Coca-Cola Football League stages games in every region of England. But when the playoffs arrive in North London, they click into a different gear altogether. Almost 200,000 fans will be gathered at Wembley this weekend, all of them anticipating something really special.
Everybody here, let's get into it, get stoked, get it started,
It's Wembley and the bank holiday weekend for the start of the playoff carnival, and the pitch looks as though it'll do justice to the occasion. It's the seventh one to be laid since the stadium reopened just over 2 years ago. So we start with the Coca-Cola League 2 playoff final between Gillingham and Shrewsbury, live on Sky Sports 1 and HD1, that's channel 408. Welcome to Wembley Stadium for the first of the playoff finals. Gillingham against Shrewsbury for the right to play in League One next season. Already there is Andy Scott, the manager of Brentford, the champions of League Two by 6 clear points. Good to see you, Andy, and well done again for that achievement with Brentford. Fantastic. You're well out of this, but I'm sure you can appreciate for these two teams today, it's the most special game of the season, isn't it?
The playoffs are great. Everyone wants to go up by the playoffs, but it's getting there. It's the tricky part, and the nerves of today. You know, both managers will be feeling awful. It's been 2 weeks nearly since they played last, so it's been a long build-up to it. So they'll just want to get out there and play.
And we mentioned the right to play in League One next season. And you look at League One. What a division that's going to be, with the likes of Leeds still, Norwich, Southampton, Charlton, yourselves.
It's great for us as a small club in that league to be playing against all those big sides, and that's obviously the pull for Shrewsbury and Gillingham today. They'll be saying to their players, do you want to go and play at Norwich and Charlton, or do you want to play, no disrespect to Accrington, go to Accrington? And it's a massive difference. Norwich have sold nearly 20,000 season tickets, so the financial implications are huge as well.
Been a long gap, hasn't there, between the end of the season when you got promotion and now when you've been to Las Vegas and back with the club, haven't you, as a holiday? Nice tan. And these boys have had to be carrying on training and working out getting the right balance between peaking and going over the top, haven't they?
Yeah, it's going to be a difficult task for both managers for 2 weeks, just to get them and lull them a little bit so they're not too nervous and waste all their adrenaline and to think too much about the game that's coming up. You know, the first week, I would have thought they would have taken them away for a few days, just relax, get a bit of bonding going, and then start this week building up towards a normal game as you would do a league game.
OK, the Shrewsbury Danger Man is the League Two Player of the Season. Grant Holt has been enjoying the country air with Patrick Davison.
For many players, it's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. But for Grant Holt, the League Two playoff final marks his Wembley return. It was 17 years ago that he last ran out at the National Stadium.
I was fortunate enough when I was 12 to play at the old Wembley as a kid, and we played in the Smith's Chris Trophy, and fortunately that day I was on the winning side, and hopefully history will repeat itself and I'll be fortunate to win on the new Wembley. It was in good junior school at the time. We had a good side, and it was a great occasion at the time. Obviously, still speak to a lot of the lads, a lot of them are still my friends to this day, and they're having a laugh and joke about it this week, so it's more fun.
Now in the form of his life, there were times when a second Wembley appearance for Holt looked a distant dream. The striker spent the early years of his career playing non-league football while holding down a full-time job.
It's a long struggle, and it makes you a better person in one way, because obviously now I understand how fortunate I am that I've gone from not playing, working as a tyre fitter and being out of the game to all of a sudden getting the opportunity to apply my trade in the biggest level, which is Wembley.
In the two league meetings with playoff final opponents Gillingham, Holt has scored 3 times, a goal in the 7-0 home win, followed by a brace in the 2-2 draw at Priestfield.
Obviously, we've had a good record again. We got a 7-0, which was a freaky game, which I think kind of write that off. They were a team at that time, they weren't really flying on all cylinders. They were a team trying to put together and working hard. But it'd be very interesting. They're a good side. They're strong at the back. They've obviously got Simeon Jackson who can score goals. But we've got nothing to fear. They'll be as scared as we scared of them. So it'd be a good game, and obviously I'm just fortunate that we're involved in it.
In all, Holter scored 28 goals this term, but he'll consider the campaign a failure unless they win at Wembley.
If I don't get promoted, then me personally, it's a season where I'll look back and in regret, really, because no matter what I've achieved this year, that's the main aim I came here to do, and if I don't achieve that, then I'll be disappointed.
Club record signing, isn't he, Andy? £170,000, but is there too much emphasis on his shoulders for him to fire every game?
Well, I think it's shown that if he doesn't perform, then they struggle, and that's why they've had such a poor away record. You know, you can't rely on him all the time, but he's been fantastic by from this year. You know, he's rewarded them with the goals, and you know, you'd like to see that they're chipping in from elsewhere. Only Ben Davies really is the other player who's scoring goals for Shrewsbury, so today might be the stage for someone else to make their name.
Do you expect a passing game today? There's one of his fans, his main fans anyway, Superman to her. But do you expect a passing game today?
Initially, probably not. It's obviously, they're two League Two sides, and they play the way that they have done to get here. And they'll be high tempo. They'll probably try and stretch the game, and then they can pass. Shrewsbury are probably the more of the passing side. Gillingham more physical. But I think once it opens up, once legs start to get a little bit more tired, there's some good footballers. They can pass it. It should be entertaining.
In the piece there, it referred to the 7-0 back in September. Yeah. Shrewsbury beating Gillingham 7-0. I know that's a long time ago, but it must be at the back of your mind if you're a player out there.
I don't know. I think Gillingham will be spurred on by that. I think it's humiliating to be beaten 7-0 any time. But Shrewsbury did it to Wickham as well, and they went up. So they're capable of scoring goals against anyone. I know Gillingham have tightened up their defensive unit since that time and developed their side, and I think they're a better side for it. They look a lot better towards the end of the season, and they're a strong outfit. It's a tough one, a tight one to call, but it's whoever settles quickly enough.
OK, Shrewsbury bringing well over 20,000 fans here today. Gillingham, well over 30,000 fans. And the man who has to mark Grant Holt is a prince among defenders. Simon King coming right up.
I look at it as my job. I've got to make sure I can't marshal the defence, keep them solid, keep them tight. And also vocally, I'm coming to that age where now I've got to start organising the lads in front of me, make their job easier, make my job easier.
Sky Sports Grand Slam Summer of Football. See England in the European Under-21 Finals. Pre-season action including the Wembley Cup and the Emirates Cup. New this season, Champions League qualifiers, plus the UEFA Super Cup. And
what a fantastic finish!
A new season of the Premier League. Don't miss a kick of Sky Sports Grand Slam Summer.
Simon Ice car shampoo tubs. There's no measuring and no mess, which gives you a Simon Ice streak-free shine every time. Just chuck it in a bucket.
Here's to the great British summer. Music festivaling, mixed mud wrestling, 14 degrees, knobbly knees, catching the rays, the big squeeze. Traffic jams, handheld fans, the hottest day since records began. Yes, we'll complain it's too hot, we'll moan when there's showers, but it's glorious, lovable, eccentric, magnificent, and ours. Bulmers Cider, squeezing the best out of the British summer.
If you want a new surfer, then today and this bank holiday you should go to DFS. You'll get the surfer you want at a price you will like. Because right now you can get half price on a surfer that's your style. You'll get 4 years interest-free credit and you won't pay anything for a year. So do yourself a favour and come and see the half-price Zeta collection at DFS. It's all about you.
I'm Ozzy Osbourne and I'm the Prince of Darkness. All aboard!
The Lich King is the Prince of Darkness, Ozzy.
Well, maybe you're the one riding a crazy train, but I've been the Prince of Darkness since 1979.
There can be only one Prince of Darkness.
Giant!
World of Warcraft. Try it free at trywarcraft.com.
With millions of great value deals, you too can still go away with Teletext Holidays. Don't miss out, visit teletextholidays.co.uk today.
Sky Bet. It matters more when there's money on it.
Both Gillingham and Shrewsbury average around 5,000 and 6,000 for a normal league game. There'll be well over 50,000 fans here today. It's the enduring magic of the playoffs, and we have Andy Scott, the Brentford Champions manager, here with us for this game. And we talked there before the break about the 7-0. Do you think Gillingham have improved defensively since September then?
They've kept the same side and the same players, but they've just developed a more solid unit. Before, they were a little bit more gung-ho with both fullbacks and would leave spaces at the back, but they've tightened up a lot. We noticed that when we played them towards the end of the season. They were a lot more solid. Simon King has really taken the role of that central defender in hand, and he's developing his game and he's organising people around him. And Gary Richards alongside him is a very strong lad, wins a lot in the air, and they complement each other very well.
Simon King there is the Gillingham Player of the Season. And he certainly knows what jobs he has to do this afternoon.
First and foremost, I think we've got to make sure all the players got to go out and enjoy it, because it's not every day you get to play at Wembley. I think Gillingham, we're a good passing team, so we've got to make sure we get the ball down. And then I look at it as my job. I've got to make sure I kind of like marshal the defence, keep them solid, keep them tight. And also vocally, I'm coming to that age where now I've got to start organising the lads in front of me, make their job easier, make my job easier.
Gillingham were on the end of a 7-0 drubbing by Shrewsbury earlier this season. Their main danger man, Grant Holt, only scored once that day via the penalty spot.
He's certainly going to be a handful. But I've played against him a few times now at Forest and at Shrewsbury, and he is a good player and he has scored a lot of goals. So we're certainly going to have to be on our game to watch him and hopefully come off better and keep a clean sheet and make sure he doesn't score. I know we did get thumped 7-0 and that's embarrassing. You never want to go for that as a footballer, but in a way, I think it was a good thing, because I thought it brought us closer together after that. I thought we maybe took the foot off our gas the previous games before that. And then, to be honest, it was just a bad day at the office. Everything they hit went in.
Whilst they'll be wary of Holt and company, Gillingham have one or two stars of their own who'll be looking to play a major part in securing their return to League One.
Simeon Jakes had a great year. He scored loads of goals. He's a fox in the box, as they say. He certainly knows where the back of the net is. And we've got bags of pace, we've got Andy Barchin, we've had another good season, we've got Curtis Weston, Stuart Lewis bursting from midfield. So yeah, I've just got to make sure back four do our job, and then I think in front of us, we've got so much pace and ability in front of us, they're going to do a job for us.
If the full-time scenes in the semi-final at Priestfield are anything to go by, the celebrations will be something special if the Gills triumph at Wembley.
I think we'll be allocated something like 38,000 tickets, so to be celebrating in front of those Gills fans will be a great feeling. I'm sure everyone associated with Gillingham will be very happy, and it'll be a great day to remember.
Andy Scott played with Simon, didn't you, at Oxford?
Yeah, he was always a very good young player, very level-headed. I don't think he believed in himself back then. He was released at a very early age by Ian Atkins, but he went to Barnet and he was playing regularly, did ever so well, got a very good move to Gillingham, and his game's come on bundles.
So he's done the non-league bit, Simon, come through there, and there's a strong element at Gillingham, isn't there, of non-leaguers, mainly Stevenage and Grays, where Mark Stimson's managed and brought through players with him. Is there a problem sometimes there, you bring through non-leaguers and the camp splits into two in the dressing room?
I think that was probably the case when Mark first took over, because he had a lot of players from the Championship and League One who weren't used to non-league players. The non-league players have come into it, and really they've taken hold of the club, and they're, you know, the ones that are really driving the club forward now, and everyone has to fall into line. You either like it or you're out. And Mark's, you know, very sure about what he wants. He's got a good set of young lads there. Like Simon said, they've got a lot of pace about the side. They're very enthusiastic, they're confident in their own ability. And some of them have got Wembley experience, which is vital again today.
It's a career-changing game, isn't it, for, well, fans, for players and managers. We'll be speaking to both of them in a few moments' time.
The World 2020 Grand Slam Summer on Sky Sports.
At PC World, get this stylish Dell laptop. With a 3GB memory, it's an excellent multi-purpose laptop for the whole family. Plus, it's available in a range of stunning colours. Only $399.99. Or get it free when you sign up to mobile broadband with 3. And get complete online protection with Kaspersky Internet Security 2009. Half price at $24.46. PC World.
This year, you can save an average of £75 on your inkjet printer ink by switching to a Kodak all-in-one printer. Switch to high-quality, low-cost printing today. See how much you could save at printandprosper.com.
Whatever happens, I want my style to be under control.
New Mineral Control Gel Paste from Studio Line by L'Oreal. Enriched with minerals. The hold of a gel, the suppleness of a paste, and no gunk. Controls invisibly all day and cares for your hair. New Studio Line Mineral Control from L'Oreal.
For a look under control, we'll work it.
At Halfords, Garmin sat-navs now from only $99.99. This Garmin with free traffic updates can reroute you to avoid jams. Now only £109.99, £30 off. Plus you can reserve online and collect in store. And with free setup and demo, you can drive away with it working. At Halfords now.
Officer Fisher,
I've got your wife.
I'm gonna hunt you down and I'm gonna kill you. 12 rounds.
Some crisp Batavia lettuce and a freshly toasted bakehouse roll, together with some Cornish smoked British bacon and a succulent piece of chicken breast fillet. That's what makes a chicken legend with bacon. That's what makes McDonald's.
HSBC can make things a little easier. Before you arrive, we can set up your mortgage, bank account and credit cards for you. Our international service is available at no extra charge to all Premier customers. HSBC, the world's local bank.
The next generation of television has arrived with sharper images and brighter colours. The ultra-slim Samsung LED TV.
I bet it matters more when there's money on it.
Welcome back to the League Two playoff final between Gillingham and Shrewsbury. And let's hear from both managers, Mark Stimson and Paul Simpson. Mark Stimson, Gillingham manager, has been here before, but that was in his non-league days.
Today's a totally different game. You know, we're facing a very good Shrewsbury side who
give us a good hiding at their place this season. In the second game, we had a 2-2 with them, so we know we're going to be in for a tough game, but we've just got to go out there and try and play our own game, and if we do, I think we could come away winners.
Paul, you come into this game having lost only two of your last 14 matches. How valuable is a run of form like that going into a game like this?
Well, I think the team that comes in on that sort of run of form has a great chance. We know that the form will go out the window, it's one of them games, but we'll go in with confidence, and that's the big thing. The players have been lifted by the performances at the end, have been lifted by the preparation, and now we're just all looking forward to getting started.
What's your message to your players today?
To try and enjoy it and play with the freedom that I like to give the players, but also make sure you're tight at the back, because in the boy hole he can cause a lot of problems if you're not switched on.
I think the big thing you've got to do is enjoy it. You've got to go out and savour these sort of moments. It's the best stage in the world to go and play in front of a massive audience. Go and enjoy every minute of it and try and remember it for the rest of your life.
Thanks, Paul.
Thank you.
Andy Scott is here, the champions Brentford. Can you appreciate what they're going through now, Andy?
No, and I'm delighted. They keep saying about enjoying it. I think the only people that are going to be enjoying it are us watching it. I don't think they can enjoy this. Not until after it's over and they've won. They're going to try and be persuading their players that they should be enjoying it, but it's really hard to mask it. You can tell there, you can tell in their eyes that they're
and you can tell why it's the best way to go up and the worst way to stay down, isn't it?
Without a doubt, yeah. If you could choose a way to go up, you'd do it at Wembley, but it's an awful place to lose.
Time to back your hunch. Where do you think it's going to go today?
I think it'll be a tight one, but I'm going to go for Gillingham. I think they've developed very well over the season. I think they're a little bit stronger, and a bit more movement up front will cause Shrewsbury problems.
OK, let's get the team news now from our commentators, Gary Birtles and Bill Leslie.
Well, for both sides, the formula that got them here to Wembley is the one to try to take them beyond. Gillingham sticking with the same 11 that started both legs of the semi-final against Rochdale. Simeon Jackson was the match winner. His 20 goals this season make him their top scorer. Barry Fuller, the captain, he's a boyhood Gillingham fan, and along with the opposite fullback John Nutter, the two in this lineup that have played here at Wembley before, both veterans of that FA Trophy win with Stevenage 2 years ago under Mark Stimson. Paul Stimson goes back to the side that started the final day must-win game at Dagenham. Chris Humphrey scored that afternoon. He's fit again and back in the midfield. The task of partnering 28-goal Grant Holt falls to the former Everton striker Nick Chadwick. Just two of this side started the playoff final defeat here 2 years ago. Kelvin Langmead and Neil Ashton. Adam Miller missed both semi-finals injured, but he's back on the bench for Gillingham. Omar Risa and David Worrell, the two from the semi-final win for Shrewsbury, who drop out of the starting lineup today. A long 13 days then since these two clubs booked their place here at Wembley. That's an awful lot of time to think, to focus about this moment. Walking out at Wembley Stadium. Some managers try to tell you that this is just like any other game. One look around will tell you it is pretty far from that. What makes these playoffs so enthralling, so enticing, so entertaining is the gap between success and failure. It's a gap that just gets wider as the weekend goes on. Now, when these two sides last sized each other up for a kickoff back in mid-March, just around 6,000 fans were waiting at the Priestfield. Today, around 10 times that many, and a match, you could say, Gary, is about 10 times, 100 times perhaps, more important.
Absolutely, couldn't be more right. And listen to both managers saying, go out and enjoy it. You want to enjoy it, you want to savour the occasion as a player, because you might not get there again, but it's so difficult in this atmosphere. You've just got to start the game so positive, get your first tackle in, get your first header won, get your first touch right, but as I say, it all goes out the window in this sort of atmosphere, because you're uptight, you're nervous, and you should be nervous, because it's an absolutely brilliant occasion.
Barry Fuller, the Gillingham captain, doing the introductions. Lord Mulwinney, the chairman of the Football League, and the presentation party from Coca-Cola making their way down the line. The Gillingham side, who finished 6 points better off than their opponents here today. Also, as part of the presentation committee, representatives from all our armed forces. Big day out for them as well. Today, it is the Royal Navy's turn. Clive Oliver is the match referee today. There's his wife, Deb. Big weekend for her as well. Her son, Michael, 23 years old, will be in charge of tomorrow's League One playoff final between Millwall and Scunthorpe. Well, so much about the approach is dictated by the approach of the managers, Gary, isn't it? They try their best to be relaxed, to keep their players in that frame of mind, but goodness me, with that big 13-day gap, it's got to be difficult, doesn't it?
The build-up, it must be a nightmare for players. I know it is, because people are asking you for tickets. You just want to get away from it. The press are after you. Some managers take teams away and just relax them, get them away from all that pressure. And it's a big job, one that's not easy to do as a manager, but they have to somehow do it, take all the pressure off the players, and then when it's time, like now, they get out there and they have to do the business. The manager's done all he can at this moment.
Well, it very nearly is time to get underway. First of all, it's time for the national anthem. Mouth-watering of climaxes to all four domestic divisions, and we get underway next.
It's been an unbelievable journey. 9 months, 48 matches, and over 70 hours of nail-biting action. There's been first-minute howlers, last-minute winners, own goals, great goals, and sitters even you'd have scored.
Being a fan of Shrewsbury Town means so much to me.
To be a Gillingham fan means the world to me. My whole family has supported them ever since I was a young girl.
Been here 2 years ago, we failed. We owe it to everybody that we actually cross that line now and get into League One.
Just give your all, that's all you can do.
Go out and win it for us. I mean, it means everything to us.
Come on, Jill, you can do it.
This is the last game of the season. It's what we've spent, you know, the last 40 odd games of the season fighting for.
Look how far you've got.
It's where your budget thrives.
If Jules win and get into League One, I'm going to get a tattoo there.
Come on, Jill.
Just doing it for fans, diehard fans, not part-time glory hunters.
Now, it comes down to the biggest game of them all.
Come on,
Jill.
Sky Bet. It matters more when there's money on it.
It's the start of the playoff finals, beginning with Coca-Cola League Two, Gillingham against Shrewsbury, for the right to play in League One next season. Commentators Gary Birtles and Bill Leslie.
Well, who is going to be the hero here at Wembley this afternoon? Last year at this level, Liam Dickinson got the winner for Stockport County. Grant Holt, 28 goals this season, £170,000, very well spent for Shrewsbury Town. And he rediscovered his goal-scoring touch here against Gillingham this afternoon, a club he's already scored three against this season. On the flip side, Simeon Jackson, £150,000, Gillingham forked out for the young Canadian. He is banging form, he was the difference in the playoff semi-final. Can he be the difference on this season-defining date this afternoon at Wembley Stadium? Well, the strikers, Gary, always seem to be the focus of attention on
day like this, but it's all about team performances. Which of the big players can turn up with their big games on the big day, if you like?
Well, I think the key to this game is the back fours, the respective back fours. Can Shrewsbury deal with the frightening pace that Gillingham have up front? And can the Gillingham back four deal with Grant Holt? And for me, whoever comes out on top as a back four, I think is going to win this game.
Well, it is Stimson against Simpson. All the I's will be dotted, the T's crossed in their meticulous preparations to be Wembley winners, to be League One managers next season. Paul Simpson, for so long this season, his side were tipped as automatic promotion contenders. Deep breath from the managers, and his players will be gulping in the North London air into their lungs just as deeply. They'll derive confidence, Shrewsbury, as well, from the fact that when they have had to win in these last few weeks, in these closing weeks of the season, they have managed to do just that. Gillingham have saved their best form, their consistency for the end as well. It's a fascinating matchup. It could go all the way. The back of minds, of course, that 7-0 defeat back in the opening weeks of the season that Shrewsbury dished out. That is a long, long time ago now, and this is a very different stage to the Pro Star Stadium in September. Well, Gillingham won the toss. They are in their home strip. They're in the home dressing room here at Wembley. Shrewsbury in their change outfit today will get matters off and underway. The playoff weekend has begun. Hold on tight. Predictably, Shrewsbury look immediately for Grant Holt up front.
Of course they will. He's the man who leads that line so well for Shrewsbury. They have to get players from midfield around him. So important they do that.
Interesting contrast in formations. We'll see how that pans out after these early exchanges. King against Holt. That's going to be a key contest here. Just hooked away in the nick of time by the Gillingham captain, Barry Fuller. Shrewsbury have started like they really mean business.
That's what I said. Which back four are going to deal with the respective forward lines better? Straight away, Grant Holt gets the upper hand in the box. Well, we know how good he is in the air, and this just goes to prove it. Long hanging ball, just backs in, gets the downward header, nobody coming in to capitalise, and Shrewsbury just get it away. But look at him, he knows exactly what to do in that area. He battles with his centre-half, he holds them off, and just puts it across the face of the goal, hoping that somebody's going to come in.
They've really shut up shop at the back recently, Gillingham. Four clean sheets in their last five games. Just that one goal conceded at home against Rochdale in the semi-final. Still inside the first 90 seconds, but Shrewsbury are certainly having the better of these early exchanges. Touch from Coughlan, their captain. Of course, all the publicity pre-season in the build-up was about the arrival of Grant Holt at the Pro Star Stadium, but Coughlan, in his own way, has been just as key at the back, the 34-year-old Dubliner. Bartram, first chance for the former Spurs product to try and have a run at the Shrewsbury Town defence.
And this is the problem he's going to cause them, and Ollie and Jackson. When they get the ball, they'll just turn and run, try and commit it, try and get beyond the back four. So Bartram put the ball across the face of the goal for Jackson to score his goal in the semi-final. He'll be looking to do exactly the same today.
Well, if you take 37-year-old Simon Royce out of the equation, it is a very young and hungry Gillingham side. That's something they will hope will stand them in good stead here. Bartram certainly comes into that category.
I was convinced it was a corner there, Bartram.
Together here from different areas. Shrewsbury, who have not been able to play at the third level in 12 years. Gillingham, the momentum has largely been a downward one over the last four or five years since they won that playoff here against Wigan in 2000 after extra time in such dramatic style. Got up to the championship, a couple of relegations in the space of the last three, four seasons, and find themselves at the bottom level again. It's a real chance here to bounce back immediately. No, as Simon Royce has experienced most things since he turned professional, playing for Haybitch Swifts as a part-time painter and decorator when he turned professional with Southend back in 1991. This is the first time he's played at Wembley, fulfilling as it is the ambition of all footballers, one here today.
Quite a few of us come from the building trade, don't we? Don Leigh.
He does the painting, others lay the carpets,
exactly.
Gary.
Exactly. We all play our part.
Well, it's certainly something that Gillingham have drawn on, the fact that non-league hunger, as Andy Scott was touching on before the game, a lot of these players, in fact, 7 out of the 11 out there, have played at one stage in non-league football. Mark Stimson, of course, enjoying his managerial success at non-league level. 3 seasons in succession with Grays and then with Stevenage, winners of the FA Trophy.
It just shows if you've got the confidence to do that, bring non-league players in, you'll get your rewards from them. And Stimson has seen that. He's brought players in, a number of them, and they've taken to league football quite comfortably.
Shrewsbury will feel that their last trip here to the capital will stand them in good stead. When they went to Dagenham on the final day, they knew anything other than a win and they would be playing in League Two again next season. They won that game today, slightly more salubrious surroundings than the parking in Dagenham Stadium, but the same applies to them. Really not for Simeon Jackson.
Up he gets, thankfully. This is why, oh, there's the head, right in the back of his head. Unintentional, but they hurt.
Well, John Nutter, one of the former Greys players in this side, will launch this one in and launch it in pretty effectively. Wasn't far away from creeping in round the back either, Barcham.
It's a decent delivery, whipped to the far post. Dangerous ball in, difficult to defend. Like it's going beyond everybody. Barsham gets ahead on it, but can't get it back across the face. Settled a little bit now, haven't they? Selling him after a good start by Shrewsbury.
We heard Paul Simpson said before and mentioned that 7-0 win. They also, when they played more recently at the Priestfield, drew 2-2. With 2-0 up Gillingham until the last 11 minutes or two from this man. Grant Holt changed the proceedings that day. Holt looking to turn provider this time. In goes a rash looking challenge from Fuller. He takes a nervous look at the referee. Just a goal kick though.
He did look a bit rash. A little smile on Mr. Oliver's face. Got a good view of this. There's the head. Just pulls out, doesn't he? Just pulls away. There's no appeal here. There's the head. There he pulls out. That's good refereeing. Had to get that right.
Josh Wright, the youngest in the Gillingham side.
So impressed with him in the semi-final. Just holds in there, he's always available, protects really well and lets the other players get forward with pace in front of him.
Speaking with pace, that's something that Simeon Jackson is more than able to exploit. Oli is another one, he closes in. Should be able to clear it away though, Ashton. Therefore, take a little help from his captain, Coughlin, though. Neil Ashton bound to be nervy. What a torrid semi-final couple of games he had.
Didn't he just? I think Coughlin was saying, that's how you do it. That's where to put it. Don't try and be clever.
Interesting to read Mark Stimson's notes in the Wembley souvenir programme here this afternoon. He says it's vital his side don't come here and try and score the perfect goal. They need to just play their game. Cited the example of Ricky Hatton, 6 weeks of planning before his fight with Manny Pacquiao. It all went out of the window as he went gung-ho. Didn't want his players to do the same thing.
No need to. Just get acclimatised, get used to the surface, and then just see what happens as you go along.
You mentioned the surface. It looks absolutely pristine, this seventh different pitch that has been laid here at the National Stadium since it was open for business.
Well, I had a walk on it and it felt fabulous. It wasn't too hard. It was perfect. It was a joy for players to play on a surface like that.
And it has plenty of football to host before the bank holiday weekend is out. good, isn't it, to have these playoffs back in the ascending order, if you like. Sometimes World Cup commitments, European Championship commitments for Championship players means that the big final has to be played first. This time, though, it starts off good and it gets even better. Here's Holt now to try and get the better of Brighton King. Well, they were caught in two minds there, weren't they? Both players, Fuller will win the day and be able to clear it away up towards Dennis Early.
Got a little bit lucky, didn't he, there? Holt just slid it in there. Davis thought he was second favourite. So it proved in the end. Holt latches onto it now. He's got good vision, sees the pass on there, and you think Davis is just going to come in, but I think he thinks his marker's going to get there first and the chance disappears.
Ollie, who would be a centre forward by trade, but has in this Mark Stimson 4-3-3 formation been employed coming in from the right.
Strength, the volley, perseverance.
And so to Gillingham comes the first corner of this League Two playoff final in the 10th minute. Gary Richards up from the back, Simon King too. Langmead with the header to meet it, it's not properly clear. A fine effort, blocked away though.
There's been a number of those sort of fouls so far in the first 10 or so minutes, as you'd expect. Both teams settling down. Referee is important, but he gets off to a good start, and he has done so far.
Little slip there from Moss, Mr. Reliable. He's known as in the Shrewsbury dressing room. Langley came across to cover rail, read the situation, didn't he?
Looking for that pace, aren't they, Barton? Knows if he gets beyond, he will cause Shrewsbury all sorts of problems.
From Simeon Jackson. And Luke Daniels, the hero of the piece, no doubt about it, in the semi-final. Davis. Well, Ashton will prepare to launch this one in for Shrewsbury. Holt comes close, only sticking with him. There is a criticism of Grant Holt there. It's the way that he doesn't spend enough time in the place where he can really hurt teams.
I've always said he's too honest for his own good. He's always available. He always comes towards the ball. And sometimes he gets isolated out wide when he needs to be in the box. And they did ride their luck a little bit against Bury, didn't they? Daniels performed an absolute masterclass of goalkeeping in that second leg.
They really had to dig deep, didn't they? Playing almost the whole of extra time at Big Lane with 10 men as well after Stephen Leslie, who's of course suspended here today, was sent off.
Well, they missed a penalty, didn't they, Barry? And numerous chances, but just didn't make it pay. I'm sure he's given Shrewsbury a great deal of confidence, or he should have done.
Gillingham player of the year, Simon King on the ball.
really good partnership, haven't they? King and Richards at the back there, so comfortable, complement each other.
Stuart Lewis, the Barry Fuller, Josh Wright. Gillingham have certainly settled now, haven't they? John Nutter.
It's one and two touch at the moment, isn't it? You like to see.
Western. Nutter on the run. He'll take it on his right foot as well. Came off the back of Coughlin. Still John Nutter. And Nutter again. He's on a one-man mission to destroy Shrewsbury here.
And you'll have to see that. Your full-backs get forward and he just carried on and carried on going forward. Just followed everything there.
It was his run into the penalty area against Rochdale that earned the decisive penalty down at the Priestfield. When they get their running game going, if you like, that's when they are dangerous. When the runners beyond the front man and John Nutter fulfilling that brief absolutely perfectly there.
Shrewsbury are really aware of that, dropping a little bit deeper, denying that space behind them a little bit, because if you play a high line, it gives people with pace more chance to get in behind them. Just don't want to see that. Shrewsbury back four.
Here's Curtis Weston. Nutter again. King looks for Oli. Ashton prevails this time. Oli snaps back at him.
And he's been going forward, but proves he can get back and get a tackle in as well.
Couldn't turn it towards any of the supporting cast that were with him.
Oh, what a good battle that was between Richards and Holt. So that's going to be a key element of this game. Those two comes out on top.
Ashton this time, that one. Coughlin as ever there to save the day for Shrewsbury. Chadwick the jumper with Simon King this time.
He's struggled to get in the game so far, hasn't he, Chadwick? Holter has been the stronger of the two so far. Get the ball to his feet if at all possible, Chadwick. At the other end, Shrewsbury back four are coping at the moment with Jackson and his pace.
Well, despite it being a winning side at Kid Lane, you can see why Paul Stimson made the changes back to the side that won at Dagenham on the final day, and the side, albeit, that were narrowly defeated by that slightly freak own goal at the Prostar Stadium in the first leg of the semi-final. Ball from Luke Daniels, and a claim from the young on-loan West Bromwich Albion keeper.
It's comfortable for him, wasn't it? Saw it early, came and collected. It's important that the manager gets in his mind his best start in 11 and sticks to that start in 11. Gives them that belief.
Oli, there we see the pace as he leaves Ashton in his wake. Jackson in the middle, Bartram joining him. So to Stuart Lewis, taking up a useful position on the edge of the box. In by Curtis Weston. And of all the options available, that perhaps the least effective of them.
Oli again does tremendously well, cuts inside, does the right thing, laid it back, and just poor quality. And final ball that let them down there.
A little flick from Holt there. Took Richards to go in strongly to get it away. Chadwick leaning in. Free kick will go Richards and Gillingham's way. Gary Richards, one who will feel he's due the big occasion. He missed out on the big FA Cup tie that Gillingham had this season against Aston Villa. And back in his Colchester days, he was suspended for their big day out. You might remember they had a draw at Jose Mourinho's Chelsea. He was suspended for that after being sent off in the game before. Very much part of things here on Gillingham's big day at Wembley. And by Fulham. Now Wright. Weston. Cut off at Sourcewell by Ashton. Gillingham starting to dominate. Dennis Oley. Trickery in by Dennis Oley. Away by Kelvin Langley for Shrewsbury. Wright, the teenager. Bartram. And Shrewsbury get a chance to come out through their youngster of the piece, Chris Humphrey. Got two for company. That's why King is Gillingham's player of the season.
He reads the game so well, doesn't he?
Who's John Terry, they call him. Sadly, he's an absolute pivotal role at the back. We heard him talking just before kickoff about the responsibility he takes for the clean sheets. Well, there are four of them, as we were saying, in the last five games.
Well, you want 11 captains out there, don't you? He takes that on board.
As the Gillingham chairman, rough times at the club last season as they were relegated to League Two, says he's fallen in love with the game all over again this time round, as Mark Stimson has guided Gillingham to this playoff final. Here's Weston, good cutback ball. Jackson was setting his sights. Shrewsbury are no mean shakes at the back themselves these days.
That's the way forward for Gillingham. They have to reach that defence, get around them, down the sides. Langmead and Coughlin are so strong in the air in the box.
It's classy by King to start it off. He's been left upfield. Here's Josh Wright. Now Weston, the former Millwall player. Really taken to their surroundings now, Gillingham, aren't they? Using the full width of this Wembley pitch. Back comes Grant Holt. Everything you need to know about the straits that Shrewsbury are in if he's picking up the ball closer to his penalty area than to the opposition's.
They're just moving the ball better at the moment, Gillingham. One and two touch.
They're playing like a side, aren't they, that have saved their best till last, unbeaten in their last six games. Just had a little wobble about a month before the end of the season, which probably realistically did for their hopes of automatic promotion. In goes Ashton, caught way too much of Dennis Oley.
Well, he's starting to cause some problems, isn't he now, Oley? Well, Gillingham, as you see there, just starting to get on top, starting to impress.
Situation. It seems necessary to send the centre halves up. It's the fullback Nutter who will take it, and Coughlin just content to get it away, puts it behind for a corner. Gillingham pressure halfway through this first half continues to mount.
Well, every chance they get, they're putting the ball in that area there, making Shrewsbury defend, and Langmead and Coughlin so far have had to do quite a bit of that.
Weston, time to pick the pass. He picks it well for Wright.
Well, that is a chance, isn't it? And that's poor defending from Shrewsbury. Totally switched off, just expecting the ball to come in the box. It's good thinking by Gillingham. Play the short one. Look at that. Nobody near the ball. All the time in the world to lay it back and all the time in the world for the shot. Not a good one. Difficult, though, comes to win quickly. Slightly behind him, but Shrewsbury have got to be more switched on than that.
And a busy season for the youngster. Played for three different clubs. Promoted with one, his contribution earlier on this season. Brentford relegated with another with Charlton. What will happen to the club where he finishes the season? It's looking good at the moment.
Winning the midfield back at the moment, Gillingham getting on the ball more, moving it across the line, getting the wide men involved. At the moment, Shrewsbury is struggling to get the ball up to Chadwick and to Holt. As you said, Holt's having to come back a little bit too deep to get involved.
Little touch from Ben Davis, in by Ashton, glance by Chadwick. Sure, they'd rather not be on the back for Shrewsbury, but it's something they have become used to, doing it the hard way as they fought their way into the playoffs. Only that last day win at Dagenham, of course, got them there.
At the moment, Gillingham are getting their key players involved, the wide players. Humphrey for Shrewsbury's only had a kick so far, and they need to get him in on the ball and use his pace, but he's having to defend and help out his midfield and the back four.
In a case, Gary, of this 4-3-3 formation, the extra man in midfield, just dominating things, is that the reason?
At the moment it is, yeah. I said before, it's one and two touch football. That's what you should practice in training, that's what we always use to practice. And the reason for that is because you move the ball quicker, you don't get closed down as much, and that's exactly what Gillingham are doing. They're making it so difficult for Shrewsbury to get anywhere near them when they're on the ball.
Well, the bookmakers found it hard to split these two sides in terms of who was favourite. Gave Shrewsbury, most of them, a narrow edge because of the results during the season. Not to know which way it would affect the match, if at all. Would it make Gillingham nervous? Would it make them more hungry? Seems to be more of the latter, the way this match has panned out so far.
More energy about their performance at the moment.
Stuart Lewis. Coughlin again having to dig it out from the very heart of the Shrewsbury Town defence.
They're asking questions of the Shrewsbury back four every time they go forward, whether it's in the box or it's out wide. They're making them defend really hard, and how long can they do that for, Shrewsbury?
Barcher, here's Jackson, good defending by Langmead. Flicked back in by Lewis, that's Coughlin away.
Shows how important good centre-half partnerships are in football. We always talk about strikers, but Langmead and Coughlin, again, like Richards and King, complement each other so well. So important you get that continuity.
Well, he comes short. Humphrey. And maybe the outlet here for Shrewsbury couldn't find a way past John Nutter.
Again, so deep, isn't he? To come back, and it's difficult then to be able to propel yourself forward and get into that space in front. And Gillingham do it, they've got Oley and Barcher further forward.
Holt, Chadwick. Oh, Shrewsbury have a free kick.
Being a little bit amused by that decision, but it's right in front of the assistant. It's difficult to get involved in the game so far. That just gets them. Flick and just a little nudge in the back, flag goes straight up. Don't argue.
In situations like this have been at a little bit of a premium for Shrewsbury recently. McIntyre will take. High hanging one, and it was easy enough for Royce to claim it.
Well, there's the difference. Every time Gillingham have put the ball in the Shrewsbury box, they've had to defend it. One chance they get to do it, throws breaks straight to the goalkeeper. The referee's gone about this game in a really unfussy manner, hasn't he? He's been right on the spot, he's got every decision right so far. That's what you want as a player, you want a referee to be like that, especially on an occasion like this. It means so much to both teams.
He wants to show that he's setting the family standard with his son in charge tomorrow, of course.
Yeah, follow that.
So far, so good.
Yeah.
Still over an hour of the match to go here. Josh Wright standing over it for Gillingham. Cast of six in blue assembled for him.
We saw the importance of Grant Holt at the other end there, heading clear.
And try to pick it up. Well, Shrewsbury stand firm, and they've needed to do a lot of that so far. After a really strong start, they've been on the back foot for the best part of the last 20 minutes.
And you saw Humphrey pick the ball up there, look forward, and there was no Shrewsbury player in front of him, so he had to wait. And they came out. They just look a little bit more sluggish than Gillingham at the moment. So much brighter on the ball.
And when Gillingham get forward, they get forward in numbers. When they get back in numbers. It's something that Shrewsbury haven't found a way to contend with yet.
Well, there again, you see how much Gillingham are on top of this game at the moment. Putting Shrewsbury under so much pressure. At the moment, they've not got the delivery right in the box. Made Shrewsbury defend. Just looking for that spark of quality.
Davis went down. He's a key man. Usually tries to get up there with the strikers for Shrewsbury. Barely seen anything of him.
Well, they're being pushed so far back, Bill, that they're struggling to do anything offensively at the moment, Shrewsbury. But it's still 0-0. Say they've defended it well, the two centre-halves have been outstanding so far, and they've had to be.
Echoes of Gig Lane, perhaps, when the opposition had much the better of the game, but ended up second best. A towering header by Simon King. Here's Dennis Early, Simeon Jackson, a live wire ahead of him.
Well, we didn't need to play that as hard as that, just tease it into the channel. Jackson the chance, but made them defend again and put it out for a throw-in. Throw-in right in the final third.
Here's Josh Wright. Stuart Lewis into Ollie. Fuller drilled in well over the head of Oli, and could have gone anywhere off the chest of Moss behind for a corner.
Well, this time they get the quality right. They nearly go in front. One touch, put it in. It's a tack well there. Just a little flick, and that's good defending at the far post. Look how it comes, taking no chances. Excellent defending. Moss all the credit he deserves there.
Josh Wright, disguised, it's left, it's brilliantly worked and brilliantly saved by Daniels into the roof of the net. They're getting closer. John Nutter's drive, saved by Daniels.
So inventive, aren't they, from set pieces? It's always unexpected, and Trophy just aren't picking it up. A lovely dummy there, and between them there, the goalkeeper, I think it's Holt as well there. The step over there, terrific strike between the two of them. Holt and the goalkeeper, saved the day. Knows how close that was.
Yeah, you can see what they've been working on in this 13-day gap, can't you? Another short corner, another chance for John Nutter to use that left foot of his, but potentially here a Shrewsbury break. Humphrey on his own, touches it past King, but touches it straight away and out of play.
Again, there are that many bodies back for Shrewsbury. When Humphrey picks it up, he has to do that. He has to try and do it by himself, and it's so difficult for midfield to get out and join in with him when you're being penned back so much. A lot to think about there for Stimson.
Perhaps not going according to plan so far for Paul Stimson.
You can be thinking, well, at least it's still 0-0. We haven't conceded. We've been resolute at the back. Well, only three attempts, but the possession has been so much in their favour, and there's the one on target, and Shrewsbury have hardly had anything to shout about in the final third.
That's one problem that Gillingham have had, despite this pretty good run recently, where they've been so solid defensively. Goals haven't really flowed. They've scored 8 in the last 11 games.
Well, they have people on the bench who score, haven't they? Cameron. Come on, Miller.
Hoisted high, too high by Barry Fuller. Well, this is the start to a wonderful weekend of action up and down the leagues. Survival Sunday, Aston Villa against Newcastle United. You can see that, Sky Sports 1 and HD 1 from 3 o'clock. Then from 4, it's Hull against Manchester United, available on Sky Sports 3 and HD 3. And you need to use the red button to access Sunderland against Chelsea from 4 o'clock, Sky Sports 3. The relegation battle played out before your eyes, as is the battle to see who will join Brentford, Exeter and Wycombe Wanderers in League 2 next season. And indeed, Charlton, Norwich and Southampton and Leeds United.
Well, that's the second time Chadwick's been caught in this first half. This is White. There's the arm and the elbow straight across him there. It's that old adage. Do you get the leverage without doing that? Definitely didn't look the best, that one. Do so much damage when you're flying through the air at that speed and your elbow's leading.
Well, Nick Chadwick was one of those two changes made. Omar Risa started that second leg away at Gig Lane. Feeling the effects of a robust Gillingham challenge. And there's a man who knows all about that, Andy Hessenthaler, part of the Gillingham golden age, if you like. Played in that playoff final here when they were leading 2-0 going into the final minutes against Manchester City. That famous day when they ended up losing on penalties to Man City. Nicky Weaver's jumping over the hoardings and all the celebrations that followed. And the year after, Gillingham came back and did it all over again. Andy Thompson's goal, putting him in club folklore for the Gills.
Well, it's up to Shrewsbury now to try and put a little bit of pressure on Gillingham. So far, they've not managed to do that.
Ben Davis tends to enjoy firing them in from this sort of range. 13 goals from midfield. He's hit that one pretty well. He had Roy scrambling across his goal.
He did scramble, but I think he knew exactly where that ball was going there, Royce. It's a long way out. It's not hit with enough pace to trouble them. Yeah, he sees it round the post. It wasn't going to trouble him. He's making sure.
The first shot on goal from Shrewsbury. We're now in the last 10 minutes of the first half. Out comes Royce, takes command.
Yeah, some goalkeepers might have slid in, tried to handle that, slid out the box. He didn't, no chances.
First, Simon Royce came to Wembley Stadium as an 11-year-old, watching that League Cup final between Liverpool and Manchester United in 1983. Ronnie Whelan got the winner as Liverpool came from behind. Norman Whiteside scoring, you might remember, for Manchester United. Always been a dream of his to play here. It's just what he's doing now. Will he be playing for Gillingham next season? The outcome of this match might have a big bearing on that. He's out of contract in the summer, one of a scattering of players in this Gillingham squad. Here's Wright on loan from Charlton. Barry Fuller, Gillingham through and through, was here in the crowd at the playoff final of 2000 as a supporter. Davis trying to get some attacking momentum going for the Shrews, but it's in vain again. It's King for Gillingham, it's Barcham, it's Neat, it's King. This is a great run. Just got caught in two minds on the edge of the Shrewsbury box, and Davis can collect. Still King doesn't give it up. He gets the throw.
What is he doing there? Centre half. Well, that just shows the confidence. He's prepared to go forward. And maybe had it been somebody else in that position, they might have been a little bit more confident. But you've got to applaud his desire to want to be in that area.
Holly goes for the early cross. Langmead away. Might come down for Curtis Weston. Weston now looking to thread it through for Simeon Jackson. It's away, but they're having to work hard to keep it that way, Shrewsbury.
Well, Simpson will want that half-time whistle so we can get them in the dressing room and maybe try and tweak things a little bit. Because at the moment, just defending. And when they do pick it up and bring it out, there's nothing in front of them and it just keeps coming back at them.
No coincidence, is it? I've seen Simon King with that wonderful run. Sean Nutter earlier on the left back alongside him in that defensive line for Gillingham, also making a bold, ambitious run. But it's Davis on the ball here for Shrewsbury, looking to provide the ammunition for Chadwick. King away, but not convincingly so. It'll take Royce to punch it clear. Back comes Dennis Oley. Now Stuart Lewis, Josh Wright, given away in a really dangerous area, and Holt takes a swing at it.
Well, you can't be too clever at times. They're playing with so much confidence, Gillingham. They believe they could pass it out from the back, but you don't take those sort of chances there. Comes out to Holt, he's leaning back, he's off balance. Just do your job as a defender sometimes and just put it into corners. Take those sort of chances.
He has all those goals, of course, this season, Grant Holt, but just two of them coming in the last 10 games. The standards he's set, that's comparatively out of form in front of goal.
At the moment, he's doing a lot of good work in his own box and in his own half.
It's been a question of all hands on deck for the Shrews, hasn't it?
Still 0-0, that's the important thing.
Strong challenge from Dennis Oley. Now Josh Wright.
Number blue shirts forward. So much availability.
Cut out by Humphrey, he's given it to Jackson.
Just look forward there, the man on the ball's got so many options. Looks forward and two or three balls, different ones he can play. This one, a lovely bit of interchange again. They get lucky, but Jackson onto it in a flash. So he's off balance, off target, but he's not had much of a sniff and you don't want to give him that sort of time and space. Possession, and we still haven't got ourselves on the score sheet. Stop making the possession tell a little bit, get a little bit more quality into our final ball.
Well, that's got to be the concern, hasn't it, Gary? The fact that they're not going to keep having this much possession, you wouldn't think, throughout the 90 minutes.
Well, the belief's there.
Count when you're on top.
Yeah, the belief's there, the confidence there, the legs are there at the moment, they look full of running. Thriving on this occasion, aren't they, at the moment?
Shrewsbury, of course, were here a couple of years ago, beaten in the final by Bristol Rovers. Just a couple of their starting lineup, though, started that day.
There you see again, ball out of defence, nobody there.
Large swathes of this first half have been a case of defence against attack, a training game at times.
Credit, they're still in this game. They've had to defend, they've done it reasonably well. There you see, man on the ball, not many options. Must be so frustrated they can't get possession of the ball.
Lewis. Dennis Oley, good touch, takes him around Ashton. Cross comes Coughlin, he'll get that.
Well, first touch brilliant, second touch heavy. Again, Coughlin has to come out, reads it well. Denies Oley the chance to put it in the box.
Here's Weston, dancing his way almost into that Shrewsbury box. Again, it'll come back at the men from Shropshire. Fuller, Weston.
Problem is they don't push out too far and get too high the back four because they know if they do, the pace of Gillingham can unhinge them.
For all that dominance, you think of one save. Came from John Nutter, the one that really tested Luke Daniels.
And Holt in a double act to keep that one out.
time on the ball for any of the Shrewsbury playmakers, if you like. That was McIntyre, scorer of the goal that levelled it up on aggregate against Bury. Here come Gillingham again, another wave of blue. Weston into Jackson. Coughlin stood strong, really strong.
He's been fabulous for me, Coughlin. Absolutely superb. They say he's a leader, and he's proving it. There's a touch there, he stands firm, comes round, just takes the pressure off his team. Gets fouled right in front of the referee. When you're under this sort of pressure, you need somebody to dominate, and he's certainly been doing that when called up.
Be the way if Shrewsbury were to hit Gillingham with a sucker punch in this final minute of the first half. Chadwick's turn. Fuller, the captain, solid defending. He's got the throw in for his side as well.
Very well organised, Gillingham at the back, marshalled by Richards and King. Disappointing thing for Shrewsbury, I think, is the fact they've not got Humphrey or McIntyre in the game in any shape or form yet.
Jackson. Shrewsbury fans behind Luke Daniels' goal, appealing for handball. Decision not going to come, the assistant well positioned to judge. Surely the last throw of this first half. Josh Wright. Oh, Daniels had to make a really good instinctive save. And he is to the rescue for Shrewsbury again.
That's fantastic all round. Great technique when it comes in. It's a long hanging throw. Comes out. Watch the technique here. Steadies himself, gets over it. Look at that for reaction. That comes through bodies. And this is one of the most difficult saves you can make. Look how he reacts there. That looked like it was in the back of the net. Came through so many players. Brilliant save.
Is he going to have another one of those days? Here's Wright to try and test him again. They stood firm. Lewis fires it over as the half-time whistle goes. Well, it is Gillingham's half, no doubt about that. They have dominated the exchanges, but they haven't been able to make it count in terms of the scoreline, largely due to that young man again. Luke Daniels with that wonderful save late on. Earlier on, with a little assistance from the head of Grant Holt, he denied John Nutter his first goal of the season. Gillingham on top, but scores level at half-time at Wembley.
Well, Gillingham on points by a long way in the first half, but it's goals that count, and we haven't got any of those so far, so it's still all on for the second half. Andy Scott is still with us. Peter Taylor has joined us, another promotion League Two winner with Wickham Wanderers. Who'll go up with them? Well, Gillingham have come by far the closest in the first half, but at half-time, despite the huffing and puffing, goalless between Gillingham and Shrewsbury.
The final day of the season, and it's Survival Sunday. One last chance to save their Premier League lives. Shearer needs a supreme effort from the Magpies against Villa. Can Hull overcome the newly crowned champions? And it's in Sunderland's own hands, but they take on Chelsea. Survival Sunday. Who stays up? Who goes down? Tomorrow from 3, Sky Sports.
A big thank you to all our commercial vehicle drivers. The world wouldn't work without you.
Desperate to get rid of your textured walls and ceilings? There is a better way. Polysol Smooth Over covers a textured surface to get it smooth, ready for painting. And the new tools now make it even easier. Polysol, behind every great finish.
However long you've got, there are thousands of great ways to enjoy every minute of England at enjoyengland.com.
Mowing can be a pain, but not with new Evergreen Mow It Less lawn food. It's formulated to go right to the root, giving you a thicker, greener lawn. And it needs less cutting than a standard fertilised lawn. So you can spend more time relaxing in the garden. New Evergreen Mow It Less.
Last year, the UK spent £600 million on inkjet printer ink. Seems like a lot. This year, switch to a Kodak all-in-one printer and enjoy high-quality, low-cost ink. See how much you could save at printandprosper.com.
We can cut hair.
Repair cars.
Repair people.
We can speak 16 languages.
Make fairy cakes.
Grow carrots in winter.
We can play lead guitar.
Keyboard. Bass.
And the tuba.
We remember the coronation.
And every track on Gran Turismo.
We know the Sound of Music off by heart.
And make really excellent balloon dogs.
We are Milton Avenue.
Milton Avenue.
And together, we can do anything.
Turning our streets into neighbourhoods. Priceless. Meet your neighbours on July the 19th for the big lunch.
You want to bet on live football? Try in-play betting at Bet365. It's a piece of cake. Go to Bet365.com. Click in play. Pick the live match. Then predict what will happen as it's being played. With 33 in-play markets, you can bet on stuff like... next goal scorer, total corners, number of cards, how many goals in the next 10 minutes, correct score, full-time result. Bet365.com. Bet in play now.
Say you own a small business and you need to process a customer's order. Well, there's an app for that. And you also need to print out a shipping label. There's an app for that. And then you need to check if it actually got there. There's an app for that too. Yep, there's an app for just about anything, only on the iPhone.
Sky Bet. It matters more when there's money on it.
The playoff finals continue tomorrow. With the League One playoff final, Millwall against Scunthorpe. 1 o'clock, Sky Sports One and HD One. And then on Monday, it's Burnley against Sheffield United for the right to play in the Premier League. 2 o'clock, Sky Sports One and HD One. This is the Coca-Cola League Two playoff final, though, the first one of the three. Gillingham nil, Shrewsbury nil at half-time. I'd like to say Peter Taylor's joined us after some problems on the M25, Peter, but you've caught all the game, really, and have you been surprised how one-sided it's been?
Well, Gillingham are capable of really outpassing anybody, so I've been very impressed with them. I think Shrewsbury are looking too nervous for me, and the only thing problem that I think Mark Stimson's got is that he probably can't believe they're not winning because they've played so much better.
Is that the only danger, really, for them? Because teams very rarely play the same way two halves running, do they?
You just can't see Shrewsbury getting out of it at the moment. You know, you've got Grant Holt ending up playing left wing. Chris Humphrey hasn't got in the game on the right wing, and defensively they're just playing very, very deep and they can't get out their own half. They're just clearing the ball, going straight back to Gillingham's centre-halves, who are starting the attacks again.
If you get a team, Peter, which seems like it's got its eyes in the headlights like Shrewsbury have, how do you get them out of it?
Well, I think Paul will be trying to say to them to try and enjoy it, try and keep the ball a little bit more. Thankfully, the goalie then kept them in it on another couple of occasions, like he did in the playoff semi-final. I think they've got to try and enjoy the ball a little bit more, because at the minute, all they're doing is defending too deep, too much, and then they're just whacking it long to then encourage for them to defend again. So I think Paul will be saying to them, try and get hold of the ball to try and create some moves.
And Gillingham have three very bright forwards up front, don't they?
Yeah, we said about their power and pace, but it's amazing. From set pieces, Shrewsbury have been really, really disorganised, and this is a fantastic chance for Nutter. A very good save again. You know, it might have just come off Holt's head. Again, another throw-in. So, of all the play they've had, it's been set pieces that they've had the best chances from. Again, like Peter said, the keeper's kept them in it. This is a terrific save, come through a sea of bodies, and to see at the last moment and get a good hand like that, terrific.
He's on loan from West Bromwich Albion, isn't he? But he started his career at Manchester United. Without him, the game might have been over by now.
I think without him, probably Shrewsbury wouldn't have been here, because he'd done so well in the semi-final. But no, without a doubt, he's kept him in it. I imagine Mark's a little bit nervous about that, because that's what happened in the second leg, the semi-final. But maybe Paul might be using that to their advantage as well, to get a bit more confidence into the players.
They've not really been a force in front of goal, Shrewsbury, have they? But you know you've got Grant Holt in your team. You know he probably will get a chance before the game's over.
Well, I think it'd be interesting if Paul changes his shape a little bit, because I think Gillingham have outpassed them, but they've had the extra body in the middle of the park, and it's just whether he matches them or he you know, as I say, in the end, his team have got to start playing a little bit better, otherwise they're just going to defend and they will not be able to cope.
But you'd still rather be Mark Stimson than Paul Simpson at half-time, would you?
Without a doubt. I'd be delighted with the way his team have played. Like Peter said, I'm very disappointed with the way that Shrewsbury have played. In the first leg against Bury, they push Humphrey up a little bit more and tuck Davis in on the left-hand side to sort of outnumber Bury. I think they've got to do that to match up Gillingham now and give Humphrey a chance to get in the game, because he hasn't touched the ball.
Still all to play for, though. It's goalless at half-time here at Wembley in the first playoff final, and both managers have been through the mill in the first 45 minutes. 45, at least more to come in this League Two playoff final for the right to play in League One next season, alongside Andy and Peter.
Your mark.
In the UK, heart and circulatory disease kills more people we love than any other. And we worry about lots of things, from what the doctor really meant to how to make life feel normal again. That's where we come in. We're the British Heart Foundation, the charity that will give you all the support and guidance you need. So to talk, call 0300 333 1333.
Ah, isn't this nice? Just you and Carlton Palmer having a bath.
Shh.
You know that bet you lost on the game last night? Well, because the last goal was a header, Paddy Power refunded losing bets. Here you go. Put some Christy Berg on.
Before you bet, check out the money back specials at paddypower.com.
Love film?
Well, yeah.
Want an easy way to rent DVDs?
What are you talking about?
From just $3.91 a month?
I always knew how to make an entrance.
Choose from over 65,000 titles online.
We're tonight's entertainment.
We send them. You watch them. Then mail them back to us when you've finished. It's that simple.
That's it. That's good.
Even the postage is free.
That's how we roll in our house, baby.
And there's no late fees.
Crazy.
For your 2-week free trial, go to lovefilm.com.
It's the Mountain Stage, 1923.
1964 burst through.
2009 break way ahead.
1929 on the ball.
1965
taking it down the wing.
1984. Oh, he's got it.
2009.
It's the 100 meter final.
1920 on the mark. For the very first time.
It's 1930.
I am not a customer reference number.
I'm not a target market.
Always remember whose money it is.
Take me seriously.
Don't clutter your language with corporate jargon.
Don't call me by my stage name.
Don't treat me like an idiot.
Remember me. Just recognize me.
This is a company being built around you. This is Aviva.
Paddy Power will refund losing bets on the Champions League final if there's a goal scored after 85 minutes during normal time.
Are you and your grey hair facing an identity crisis?
My hair says experience. My hair says energy.
Touch of grey, the best of both. Combs away a little grey, not too much, just right.
Now I look like I have experience and energy.
Touch of grey.
Documentaries, now more amazing. Dramas, now even more gripping. And sport, now even more thrilling. Welcome to the TV you love.
Catch it.
In high definition. To upgrade to Sky Plus HD, pre-register now at sky.com/high definition. High definition. Now, it's for everyone.
Sky Bet. It matters more when there's money on it.
Amazing day of live football tomorrow, apart from the League One playoff final. There's Aston Villa against Newcastle in the Premier League. 3 o'clock, Sky Sports 1 on Survival Sunday and HD 1. And also Hull against Manchester United from 4 o'clock on Sky Sports 3 and HD 3. And also Sunderland against Chelsea from 4 o'clock, Sky Sports 3 via the red button. Here at Wembley, it's the Coca-Cola League Two playoff final. Kicked off in the usual fashion, fast and furious, but it settled down to be really quite one-sided. Gillingham having most of the play and nearly all of the chances, but it stays at half-time. Gillingham 0, Shrewsbury 0. So all to play for in the second half, for the right to go up to League One next season. And Shrewsbury having a pre-second half talking on the pitch. Let's join our commentators, Gary Birtles and Bill Leslie.
Well, when you talk to Paul Stimson, he's a pretty affable guy, gives a pretty laid-back air. I dare say that wasn't his manner in the Shrewsbury dressing room at half-time, Gary.
I don't think it would have been, but you've got to give them credit for what they've done. They've survived that first 45 minutes. They're still 0-0, and I'm sure that's exactly what he's told them. And said, right, you have the ability, but you need to get the football, because without it, they can't play, and that's what they've struggled to do.
And worth stressing, although there has been something of a one-way system in force on the Wembley turf this afternoon, we are, as we started, scores are level. We start from very much a level playing field, and indeed with the same sides out there. Paul Stimson deciding that the side, if you like, that have got themselves into this mess are well capable of getting themselves out of it, turning the tide. Gillingham, of course, looking for more of the same, but looking for that end product which could result in League One football for them again next season. A mighty noise around the National Stadium as Gillingham in blue get us underway for the second half. Certainly initial interpretations, Gary, doesn't look like there's any change in Shrewsbury system.
Not at the moment. The one thing they've got to try and do is come out from the back a little bit more. They're so frightened of getting done over the top with the pace that they are dropping too deep, and when you do that, it's difficult to get out and be offensive.
Almost the most nervous moment that Simon Royce has had in the match so far. Good pressure on him from Grant Holt. And here is the top scorer. Trying to turn provider this time. Davis gets in there well. to Gillingham defence that are so far largely untried in this match. I look to put that right, and the early signs in this opening minute of the second period is that Shrewsbury look to make a little more of a game of it in this second half.
That's a lot better. Started very, very positively. Holt again, the provider. Chadwick attacks it well, but Royce comfortably holds on to it. But that's a better start. At least they've got in that final third. At least they've got the ball in the box. Work the goalkeeper.
And they're no strangers to drawing matches this season, Shrewsbury. Over the course of the League Two season, no one drew more games than them. 21 wins for Gillingham to Shrewsbury's 17. Gillingham's problems in terms of automatic promotion is that they lost too many. They in fact lost two more games than the side whose penalty area they attack here. Nutter with a sly one in towards Bartram. Oh, clever turn from Bartram! And Daniels again, the last line of defence.
Well, they just don't learn, do they, Shrewsbury? Again, the free kick, it's an inventive one. They're expecting the ball in the box. Look at this. Nobody near him. He does excellently here. Checks back in. But again, who's there? Daniels. That is near post. Stands big.
Well, after an early Shrewsbury flurry, normal service resumed. Right with the corner. A little slip in that. They all leave it to each other. Bartram step over and Nutters. It's come all the way through to Fuller. A little too much on that. He's overcooked it.
But again, they just don't pick up on it, Shrewsbury. Just so easy for Gillingham at the moment to pick the pass, put it where they want. They're just switching off at the moment. Shrewsbury. Too many stepovers that time, though. Well, Daniel's the man who more or less single-handedly kept Berry out. And he's keeping Gillingham out as well at the moment.
It's a familiar script, isn't it? As far as Shrewsbury are concerned, but you just think if the pattern does pick up as it was in the first half, and it's showing early signs of that with Bartram getting in behind here, up comes Daniels. It's only a matter of time before Gillingham do breach this resolute Shrewsbury defence.
Well, he pulls the ball, and so he should do. Wonderful delivery, gave him the chance to get in the box. Did the right thing, chested it down, but again, Daniels comes out and thwarts him.
Won by Chadwick. Holt will try and get in there, and very nearly does, back by Richards. It was simple, it was direct, a knock-on from Chadwick, Holt causing problems. Doesn't have to be pretty like a lot of Gillingham's football has been.
Definitely not. Play to your strengths. The strength is Grant Holt, his ability to back into defenders, to make it difficult.
There's a little more finesse, perhaps, to Gillingham's game. Strength probably is the strength of Paul Simpson's side.
Strength of mind at the moment. Copley and Langmead. Daniels played the part in this game so far.
Fuller played the pass. Ashton with the challenge, which will lead to Clive Oliver giving the free kick.
I feel like the way he's referee in this game, Mr. Oliver. Close to everything. Not to get the ball there, might have got that one wrong.
Gary Richards is forward, the centre half. He's got his arm up. He wants John Nutter to fire it in his direction. He's hung up towards King, and in the end, it was Langmead that got the final touch behind.
I think every time but one, and Gillingham put the ball in, they've made that man defend. Again, it's put into the far post. And they ask the questions, and at the moment they're all being answered, but they're making them defend every time it comes in the box. Look at this. That is so one-sided, isn't it?
And they make one count, though. Daniels with a solid enough punch away. Murray first to it for Shrewsbury. There's no one in a black shirt within any sort of distance of him. He looks to release Humphrey.
Well, at least they are leaving one up. They're leaving Humphrey up before the set pieces. And everybody was going back, and when they cleared it, nobody was there. At least that pace is there and that outlet with Humphrey now.
that corner statistic, one that really does seem to tell the tale of how this game has gone so far. The one-sided nature, Gillingham have enjoyed the superiority. But it counts for nothing unless they start to make it count. And as the minutes tick on here, this Coca-Cola League Two playoff final, the longer they fail to make it count, the more the nerves will creep in to what is a predominantly young Gillingham side. Seems to have a calming word here, the referee from Northumberland.
There's no need to do this either, Gillingham. So much on top, no need to get involved. You know, the proverbial handbags there, nothing at all to get involved in, but he chose to.
Shrewsbury, who had a man sent off in that playoff final defeat to Bristol Rovers here at Wembley a couple of seasons ago, also of course a man sent off in the semi-final second leg against Bury. Still talking to here from the referee, or maybe he does feel the need for a card. It's going to be a card for Coughlin and one for Curtis Weston by the look of things.
Is it just Weston or is he going to give Coughlin one? Weston, I think, for holding on to the ball and denying them the chance to take the free kick. No, he's given him one as well, but last. There, he won't give them the ball. There, referee right on it again. And he's right to book it. Got to give the ball back. There's no need to get involved. You're so much on top in the game, and just let the opposition do that.
Coughlin floats it forward. Header one, struck absolutely beautifully by Ben Davis. By a distance, Shrewsbury's best moment.
Well, the only thing he could do other than that was put it in the back of the net. The header's won well, it's a cross, takes it early, and that is, again, really good goalkeeping. Positioned himself perfectly. Could have been flat-footed, wasn't.
Well, is it a coincidence that Shrewsbury's best moment followed the first time they really got under the opposition skin?
Well, it was King who put it back across his own goal there, and it's a fantastic strike. People say it was a comfortable save. It was, because his position was so good. Could have been the centre of goal. He wasn't.
And just to confirm for you, the two quick-fire yellow cards for Curtis Weston. Youngest ever player still to appear in an FA Cup final at 17 for Millwall. It's back by Moss.
Oh, there seems to be a little bit more purpose, doesn't there, in the play now.
Suddenly seems to have come alive a little bit, doesn't it, both on the field and off it. Atmosphere going up, a couple of notches here at Wembley as well. Off goes Weston, goes to ground under the challenge. There might be another yellow card here, this time for Paul Murray.
Certainly will be a yellow card. He knew straight away. Just done by ability there, step over. Yeah, quite right, see the step over there. Blatantly blocks him right in front of the referee again, and the referee doing what he had to.
Well, he might not appreciate too much, Paul Stimson, the fact that his side are starting to pick up yellow cards, but at least they're getting close enough in the second half to make the challenges. Ball from the keeper.
I'm just bringing the step at the moment, a little bit weary in the first half. Under that intense pressure, you're bound to be.
Shadwick leads the charge here for Shrewsbury. Now Davis, who came so close a moment ago. Definitely an air of more about them as they look to snap this Gillingham dominance. Coughlin. Langmead, the longest serving player at the Pro Star Stadium.
Not so comfortable at the moment at the back for Gillingham as it was in the first half. To do a little bit of work at the moment.
Chadwick trying to divert it towards a teammate. It's away by Stuart Lewis.
Easy for Gillingham at the back, they just brought it out at will.
halt. Now Humphrey has a chance to really attack the ball. Combination of solid defending and good goalkeeping did the job for Gillingham.
Lewis has done the right thing, he's commanded the situation, he's come out a long way up his line. There he comes, and maybe Lance Bunny. Really good goalkeeping. You like to see that in a goalkeeper, makes his mind up, comes and claims it very well indeed.
Chris Humphrey, who lipped off that defeat in the first leg of the semi-final against Bury, what looked a pretty serious hamstring injury. Immediately, though, they diagnosed it as just that. They were able to give him an injection and treatment, and always looked like he'd missed that second leg, but here he is, ready for the big day. If you are going to have a lacklustre half of football, it's much better to do it in the first than in the second.
Definitely. They put him on the left-hand side after this second half. Humphrey.
Holt rides the challenges and continues to do so. Heading the wrong way, though.
They're trying to get Humphrey in the game. Didn't get in it on the other side. Right-hand side first half. But a bit more productive second half.
Shrewsbury supporters having something to sing about here. Gillingham having something to think about as it's angled up towards Chadwick. Got the header there.
Trying to get it into Holt, didn't he? Again, Royce commands the situation.
Here's Josh Wright. Now Weston. Now Jackson. Just behind Dennis Early. Suddenly the play that was flowing in the first half isn't coming quite so easy to the men of Kent. It's Humphrey, and it's Fuller.
Certainly made Gillingham think a little bit, the switch of Humphrey to the left-hand side.
Here comes Lewis. Clever ball for Simeon Jackson. Bartram waits in a central position. Here's Jackson, deflected, finds a way through to Bartram. Bartram for Gillingham, cut back. Curtis Watson couldn't get there, nor could Lewis.
Well, again, defending of the highest order, and it's had to be. Again, Hockland guiding things from the centre of that defence. Bartram does well, holds it up, just don't get the rebounds here. They're just crowded out yet again, and how many times have we seen that so far in this match?
Tell you what though, Gary, it's feeling a lot more like a final now, isn't it?
It's one-sided, is it? We've started to get a little bit more into this.
Is the nature of the playoffs, the season's work condensed into one afternoon. Even less than that now, approaching the hour, scores level.
There's Clark coming out.
Rob Holt the recipient this time. It's three now in the opening quarter of an hour of this second half for the Shrews.
I'll say, I'm a striker, what do you expect? We don't tackle particularly well. Look at Malicious, just steps inside. There, just sticks a leg out, tries to get the ball, it is a foul. But he's been consistent, the referee.
Not the first of the season, as you can see, for Grant Holt. King sent forward. Mutter's touch, King might just get back. Possession retained well. Josh Wright. Now Weston. Look from Ollie as he looked to repeat the feat that he did in the first half on the fullback Neil Ashton. Chadwick. McIntyre. Murray. And the Cardiff Shrewsbury 3 in this second period. He's experienced playoff playing in the past as well as at Queen's Park Rangers when they were beaten by Cardiff. Trying to get their passing going and not doing a bad job here, Shrewsbury. Murray still leading the charge. Out by Holt. Holt takes up his position in the middle. And Royce is able to spoil the party as far as Shrewsbury are concerned. But it's better again.
Well, we've seen some really good goalkeeping from both goalkeepers. Both confident, both dominant. I think what Paul Simpson has told his team, the back four have got to push up. Yes, they've got pace. Yes, they might get in behind us. But if you don't push up, we're not going to get midfield involved. And so far in the second half, it's been better in that respect.
Intended it to go, collected by Stuart Lewis, known somewhat tongue-in-cheek by some of his teammates as the water carrier of the team in that midfield. It's a young midfield, isn't it? Look at Lewis, who's 21, Wright 19, Curtis Weston 22.
Yeah, full of energy, full of desire. First half they dominated that midfield, but the second half getting a bit of their own medicine.
Mark Stimson saying in the build-up to the match, here's Early looking to flick it cleverly in behind for Jackson.
Who's there again? Coughlin, the captain.
And Mark Stimson saying his young players on this big Wembley pitch might glide around like crisp packets in the wind, he said. Certainly that was the case in the first half, they were everywhere, weren't they?
Never described as a crisp packet floating across the surface.
On by Murray. Holt, good touch. Chadwick gives chase. King in there. And the offside flag up was there to deny Shrewsbury. Well, there's a good atmosphere here and a great crowd. 53,000, that's the second highest ever for a playoff final at this level. Roughly about one in every three people who live in Shrewsbury or Gillingham, the two towns, are here at Wembley this afternoon. Terrific effort by the two clubs.
Fabulous. Critics of the playoff system shouldn't be now, because they create so much entertainment at the end of the season. Gives teams so many chances to get into the playoffs. You could be so far behind and got no chance of getting in the top three if it was automatic, but the playoff positions give everybody that opportunity.
And the critics who were quite vociferous early on about the playoff system, particularly those who were involved in the third place clubs, or at this level the fourth place clubs who'd narrowly miss out on automatic promotion, seem to have been silenced. They've been around a fair time now, haven't they? 20 years. I think everyone now accepts that it is the way. If you don't get in those automatic slots, then you have to take on this. It's always said, what a wonderful way to finish off your season if you're winners. If not, you pack your bags, you cut your cloth and stay in the same division for another year.
Yeah, but even if you lose in the final, at least you've been given that opportunity to go for promotion and get there. You know, one season you could finish third, and if it was automatic, you not go up. The next season, you know, you get in the playoffs. It just makes so much sense to do these games.
It's only a final day win, of course, that got Shrewsbury here. Ashton with a free kick for them. Header well won. And McIntyre was in position A1 to do a little better than that.
Well, what a chance this is. Long high ball again. Wonderfully won there. He's in acres of space and just doesn't seem to know where the goal is. Look at him, right in between there. Tried to put too much on it. Just concentrate on hitting the target. Just got there a little bit early, try to power it in there. You don't need to do that, you just need to make decent contact, and the keeper saves it fine.
McIntyre, the man who scored the goal that got them to Wembley, or at least got them to the penalty shootout to get to Wembley, couldn't open the account at the National Stadium. King for Gillingham.
It was the best chance, wasn't it?
Solid Barton block. Back in, Chadwick was rating. Here comes Ollie and here comes Gillingham. Humphrey back just to stem the flow. There's a lot of space on that left. Bartram wants it played across there. Jackson now. Lewis. Josh Wright. Here's Nutter. Bartram. Jackson drops deep. Now Lewis, clever play, cut out by Shrewsbury. Just starting to creak a little bit, sit a little deeper as Gillingham come on. Right, Lewis. John Nutter. Fizzed in, Bartram with the touch. Couldn't get the shot to follow up. Due to that man again, Coughlin the captain. Humphrey. Take on the Gillingham skipper. Murray. Davis. Murray. Holt floating around to try and make things happen. Davis, who certainly can do that.
Long way out, but worth an effort, wasn't it? The difference this second half is they are pushing on a little bit more. They're a little bit higher as a back four. And what they're doing, they're keeping Chadwick and Holt up. In the first half, they were dropping deep to help out. I think Paul Simpson just said, right, let the midfield do that. You have to be there when we get the ball.
Well, if not quite so, the managers and players, the Wembley memory is still pretty fresh in the minds of these two sets of supporters. It did look a little different 9 years ago when Gillingham were last here for that win against Wigan to take them up to the championship. Bartram, Shrewsbury look for the foul, it's not going to come. Jackson trying to get away from Langmead.
Yeah, good high line. That's the difference for me. Switched Humphrey to the left and that's made a difference as well.
Is the target. Holt gets the better of King. In by Davis, looking for Chadwick. Richards can clear. Now Humphrey. Good whip on that one in towards Chadwick. No offside flag either.
The pressure, the ball in. Chadwick applauds it. Tries to bring it down and get his shot away. A lot of encouragement there for them Shrewsbury fans behind that goal. Didn't see much in the first half, but seen a lot more in the second half.
Ashton wants more option. The move from Murray gives him just that. He's got the better of Weston. Coughlin's header. And for one for Davis, and they'll get a free kick as well.
Find it difficult to get hold of the ball and take command again. Shrewsbury found it difficult in the first half. Good tactical awareness, I think, by the manager. Paul Simpson, second half. See what was the problem, put it right straight away.
Davis and McIntyre, the two who were meant to deliver. Chadwick and of course Grant Holt among those up there. Davis will take.
Such a bad ball, nobody got on the end of it. Decent delivery, gives you something to attack. Any sort of touch on it from anybody there causes a problem.
Now well inside the final quarter of this final. Extra time, of course, and penalties wait in the wings if they are required here. By the time we finish at Wembley, one of these two will still be in League Two, one of them will be in League One. Holt, Chadwick, Shrewsbury without a doubt enjoying their best spell of the match just at the moment, in by Humphrey.
Saw Holt coming across there, but not by King. A lot more encouraging for Shrewsbury this second half. He surprised Gillingham a wee bit. That tells you how much Shrewsbury have come back into the game. We're getting battered possession-wise first half. Second half, it's all down to, for me, the manager.
Made a few tactical switches at half-time, but still largely sticking to their tried and trusted 4-4-2 formation.
The problem in the first half, the two strikers were coming back too deep, and there was no outlet for you when you've got the ball at the back. It was just being hoofed down the front, and then it was coming stroke back at you. He's certainly stopped that happening, because Chadwick and Holt in a lot further forward positions this second half.
Of Kent and the Kentish men massed together at one end of Wembley Stadium. Familiar sight for Shrewsbury's fans. It's the same end of the same blue and white colours at that end of the ground Bristol Rovers supporters had when they were beaten here 2 years ago. This is full enough for Gillingham. Great run, good cutback, but Simeon Jackson couldn't get it go with enough.
I think it was meant for him. Weston was coming in behind.
Away by Ashton, now Humphrey. Chadwick. It's a brilliant build-up. It's Ben Davis in the box, and it's a corner.
Just seemed to stop, didn't it? The ball in the grass there. You thought he was just going to burst onto it, take it in his stride. Just seemed to hold up. Lovely ball played in there. You think he's just going to go in front. It just stops on him a little. Gives the defender a chance to come back and time this to perfection. You get that wrong to Penn.
They all wait in the box for the right delivery. Coughlin the one to keep it alive, but Royce's throw is not the best. Hit the back of a player. And Josh Wright does manfully to retain possession for Gillingham. Lewis, terrific noise around Wembley now.
Well, this is the time, approaching what, 75 minutes, your legs start to get tired. See, I think it's Richards there, stretching. Your hamstrings are a little bit tight. Going to be mentally strong.
Time for a change. Right on cue, Paul Murray, who doesn't often finish matches for Shrewsbury Town. Our most substituted player will make way. And the young, fresh legs of David Worrell will come on to replace him. Like the goalkeeper, Luke Daniels on loan from West Bromwich Albion. Initially for a month, extended to include these playoffs. It's his first taste of Wembley Stadium football. Chadwick. You'd think Worrell's brief would be to provide a little bit of width. Certainly no hint of an injury for Paul Murray. A tactical switch by Paul Stimson.
Provide them with fresh impetus, without a doubt. Give it the difference.
Certainly McIntyre operating more centrally now. Here's Josh Wright. Now Weston. Shrewsbury back off. Here's Simeon Jackson. The deflection might make it awkward. Coughlin can clear it. Only as far as Fuller. Right. Great touch.
Well, made his mind up, didn't he? Going for glory. Why not? Confident enough to do it.
And this is the first of a trio of cracking finals here at Wembley this weekend. Tomorrow it's League One. Millwall against Scunthorpe for a place in the Championship. 1 o'clock Sky Sports 1 and HD 1. And Monday, Burnley and Sheffield United fight it out for that final place in the Premier League next season from two, Sky Sports 1 and HD 1. Into the last quarter of an hour of this League Two final here now. Dennis Early for Gillingham. Weston. Fuller, who back in January was admitted to hospital with bacterial pneumonia. Well, he nearly put pay to his career at one stage, there were fears, but made a full recovery, back playing football a month later, captaining his boyhood club here at Wembley now. Davis.
Shrewsbury in the first half, they struggled to get their wide men in the game. I think second half, Parchman only have struggled to get in the game because of the change in the Shrewsbury formation.
Tatty looking linesman's flag, isn't it? Clive Oliver and his assistants Keith Lawson and Paul Thompson have been together all season. And it's not just footballers who are superstitious. Those are the same flags that haven't been washed since day one. Hot now for Shrewsbury. Worrell, the substitute, could be in here. Looks for a more patient build-up. Humphrey.
See, the correct legs got him in there. I thought he was just going to sprint onto that and take it on his left foot. Didn't he? Checked out. Got to take a chance when you get it there.
With the ball in hand. Chadwick there to cause some problems. And he scored an own goal in the first leg. Launches it in, up towards Holt.
It's on the shoulder of his centre-half, far post. The right thing, headed it down, but fortunately, Royce is in his way again. So much more difficult, haven't they? Shrewsbury in the second half, got closer to the ball, with the pressure on the ball. It's paid off for them.
Smile on the face of Omar Risa. As Shrewsbury make their second change. Well, Omar Risa, who's had an extraordinary last 15 months or so, effectively suspended from all sorts of football after he was playing in Turkish football, had a contract dispute, and his registration was withheld by the Turkish Football Association. He's only played a handful of games now for Shrewsbury, started their second leg away at Bury, and now comes on, the former Arsenal trainee here at Wembley Stadium. Played here, actually, as a kid before that famous Paul Gascoigne FA Cup semi-final between Arsenal and Spurs for the Arsenal kids. Struck shot, well saved by Luke Daniels, had his Josh Wright in the first half. Gillingham haven't really produced too much in front of goal in the second. Davis with some standout chances for Shrewsbury Town. Where is the goal going to come from? Is it going to be a moment of brilliance? Is it going to be a mistake?
Looked a foul, didn't it? Assistant was right on top of that one.
Last 10 minutes now. The goal at this stage is mightily hard to bounce back from. Those sets of supporters know that, those managers know that, and all the players out there do as well. Worrell. King gets the benefit of the referee's decision.
You know, as a centre-half, Grant Holt will do that to you all afternoon. Some you get, some you don't.
Right. Barcham. Great tenacity by Barcham. It's a good challenge by Darren Moss. Now Risa. Humphrey. Risa continues his run. Holt wants the early ball.
It amazes me when Grant Holt's in that position, the ball's floated to him. You need somebody around him.
Barcham able to spring away from Darren Moss, cleared through to Simeon Jackson. Hoffman got a vital toe in again.
Made that Moss bite as well, because Oley was bursting through the middle there. And good invention again.
Tired legs, few players just stretching off a little bit of cramp. Everything given, not just today, but over the course of a 46-game League Two campaign. It all comes down to under 9 minutes. Will it take another half an hour to split these two? Shrewsbury dominant over the two meetings in the league. Gillingham 6 points the better of Shrewsbury Town over the 46 games.
Richards really struggling out there at the back. He's been stretching non-stop.
Here's Holt. Humphrey. He's having to operate very deep again. Leaves Risa as the most advanced Shrewsbury player. For Gillingham. Offside flag against Simeon Jackson.
It's a real shame. He did exceptionally well, didn't he, Lewis? Goes past his man, gets away from him. There, maybe just delays it a little bit. Assistant flag went straight up, right in line with it. At this pace, you don't know, you need to go so early.
To this stage of this sort of a game, little things can prove important. There's Mark Stimson keeping his hand pretty close to his chest in terms of not making substitutions with extra time in mind. Two already made, of course, by Shrewsbury Town and Paul Simpson. Brilliantly intercepted by Fuller in a split second, turning defence into attack. Oli, a little ponderous perhaps. Now right. Lewis. Barcham. Right again. Lewis. Trying to get that swift one-touch passing going, but Shrewsbury won't allow it. Omar Risa. Ben Davis. Holt. Little give and go, hoping that Risa had set off, but combinations didn't quite work out.
A lot of tired minds out there at the moment, tired limbs. The energy they've spent out there can take its toll, the occasion can take its toll.
Big pitch, warm afternoon as well.
Yep.
All factors, and of course these mighty stakes under which these players are performing. One slip, one tired challenge away from playing in League Two next season, or indeed from being able to capitalise on one and playing in League One. So fine are the margins, so close is the end, and so level is the playing field. Still 0-0. The first half that Gillingham dominated almost from start to finish. The second half, well, it's been much more even, hasn't it? Maybe even Shrewsbury have shaded it.
Well, we did wonder, didn't we, for all the possession they had. They couldn't turn it into goals. Well, it had come back to haunt them a little bit. Hasn't yet. It's still 0-0, but... Well, there's the attempt. Really closed down. Still Gillingham on top. Daniels providing the big stumbling block for them.
We might have expected between them to be able to muster more than just four. Risa. Cheer from the Salukians behind Simon Royce's goal. Trying to play their part. McIntyre will have to go again with a touch from Ashton. Holt.
Very closely guarded by King. Giving him any time to bring it under control.
And when they needed to be in the first half, the Shrewsbury defence was just about on top. And when they've needed to be in the second half, you can apply exactly the same to Gillingham.
You can. Both sets of centre halves, I think they played superbly.
Right. To lead the charge from midfield. Might just come for Jackson. Across comes Ashton.
Two pieces of excellent defending the last couple of minutes from Ashton. Had to come across, had to make the challenge, did make the challenge. Got it out of the danger area.
Barcham. He's taken on two and still fancies his chances. Back towards Nutter. Away by Langmead. Risa. McIntyre. No way out though. And King renew hostilities. King comes out on top. And Grant Holt snapping back in, and back comes King again. And Holt in his eagerness to make it up.
Well, that's the foul. Before the game, the key could be how both sets of centre halves handle both sets of strikers. So far, not much to choose between them. Both performed admirably. Sticks to his task really well there, King.
Seconds of the 90 minutes remain. Not a time to take any chances, and the way Langmead defended that would suggest as much. That's a Gillingham corner in the last minute of the League Two playoff final.
Well, all you've got to concentrate now is the quality. As Barcham gets in a good area, did that rebound off him?
Attacking the end where their supporters are housed. A corner for Gillingham, a header and in! Across the line! Jackson's header sends Gillingham back to League One. There's no way back here for Shrewsbury. Right on the stroke of the 90, would you believe it?
Unbelievable, isn't it? You're looking for hero and you're not surprised. It's that man in your picture. I said it's going to be quality. It was quality. Nobody picks him up. There, clearly in the roof of the net. And once they didn't defend it, but this is pure quality. Concentrated, get it in the area, nobody picks him up, and that's a terrific header. Had to generate his power, just goes over Holt, hits the target, bounces off the shoulder and into the roof of the net. And he knows he could have taken his team to promotion. And nobody's surprised that it's him. Is it in? Yes, it is.
Well, no team is a one-man team, but the goals from Simeon Jackson look like they will propel Gillingham back to League One at the first time of asking.
Well, for how well the defender Shrewsbury, it's a big surprise he's come from a set piece, the goal. But he did pick somebody up in the centre of the goals, centre of the six-yard box. And they'll be bitterly disappointed with that.
Well, Shrewsbury need to find something quick. Langmead. Holt. Jackson, the toast of Kent for Josh Wright. To concede goals, there are great times to score goals, and depending on what colour your affiliation is, it's a little bit of both. Coughlin away in the third minute of the allotted added three, might have a bit more tagged on as well.
You do feel sorry for Coughlin because he's been outstanding in this match. One piece of quality from a set piece and they just haven't dealt with it. Never picked him up, he's got a free header, still had a lot to do with it. Didn't he do it well?
Well, this is where they want to be in all senses at this time of the match, Gillingham.
Well, what they don't want to do now is switch off and think they've won it. They're nearly there.
Leap, Jackson's touch, just when it looked like they'd run out of ideas, they found the moment of magic they needed to do what so many have tried to do in recent weeks and been unable to, and that's beat Luke Daniels. Here's the touch from Holt, helped on by Omarisa. Maybe Shrewsbury can spoil the party. Ben Davis gets the cross in, Royce Combs doesn't get there, but Coughlin couldn't capitalise. It would have been fitting had he been able to. But Captain Courageous saw his header go wide.
Well, I think Royce just does enough, doesn't he? It's a great ball put in there. Royce under pressure, but that's good defending. Did enough just to put him off. There, leaps high, but just can't get over the top of it. And he knows that might be it.
Minute of added time. Gillingham Bain praying for the final whistle. Can't be far away now.
Well, Ross Gunter can't believe it. This game's still going on.
A look at the watch from Clive Oliver. And a blow of the whistle, which signifies that Gillingham are back in League One. Their number one striker producing a goal. Almost exactly on the 90-minute mark. A header which guided Gillingham after a real season of turmoil last year, back at the first time of asking, and a goal which broke Shrewsbury hearts. A wonderful place for winners, a terrible place for losers, and Gillingham are the League Two playoff final winners here this afternoon.
Yeah, magnificent. What a time to score a goal. You're not surprised that Jackson got it. But he kept going, didn't have many chances, and that's a sign of a really good striker. The belief's always there that one will come your way, and when it did, he put it away superbly. Wasn't easy. He had to generate a bit of power, and didn't he do it well?
Well, two goals in that semi-final second leg to see off Rochdale, one here at Wembley to bring Shrewsbury to their knees and spark celebrations all the way from North London back to Kent. Paul Scally, who had some unhappy Gillingham supporters last season, even threatened to attack him in his car on the way back from a game. He's fallen in love once more with the game of football, and I bet he's absolutely passionate about it now.
Well, still talk whether it should have been a corner for the goal. This is a moment. Did turn it, there's the cross, there's the block, comes off his knee, wasn't a corner, there was a question mark when it happened, now we can see, and this is what happens. He didn't pick him up, slightly behind him. What a great header that is. Terrific header.
Well, Jackson, the man who did it for his manager, Mark Stimson, let's hear from him now. He's with Greg Whelan. From Mark Stimson in a moment as the Gillingham celebrations continue.
But what a part Shrewsbury played second half, and you just feel for that man. He put everything into that, he was superb. Give Paul Stimson credit for the way he changed it round to make a game of it. Surprised Gillingham a little bit, but that man had the belief to think he could be the match winner.
Well, so many times you see it, don't you? 7-0 was a lot of the talk when these two met, of course, all the way back in the opening 6 weeks of the season. That was Shrewsbury's margin of superiority, a draw when they met in March at the Priestfield Stadium. How would it go today? Well, they've completed the set, haven't they, of all three results. And how does their manager feel? We can now hear from Mark Stimson, down with Greg.
Big shoulders, I've got a great family around me, and they're the people I listen to most.
How do you feel?
I'm just feeling back to last year. You know, I got relegated at Leeds and I took responsibility. I put a group of players together. Yeah, some have come from non-league, but I was in non-league as well. I tell you what, these boys have got pride and passion. And if you've got that, you've got a chance. Last year, I had a lot of players who had none of that whatsoever. And they didn't help the calls. But this year, we've got a group of players now who are young, hungry.
And come on!
And you can see as well, they can play. They can play, and that's what I encourage them to do. Get the ball down and pass it. I thought we should have been a go up at half time, to be honest, but their keeper was on form. Second half, we've got the goal late. There's not a lot of time then for Shrewsbury to equalise, but we owed them one because at the beginning of the year, 7-0, and that's when people really started to point the finger at me. But I had great belief in my players. And today and tonight, all the people at Gillingham, be proud of their football team, be proud of their football players, and Chairman, that's for you.
You've had some tough times, you suggested that. This must make up for it, I guess.
Oh, more than makes up for it, because I love proving people wrong. I take it on my shoulders, big shoulders. I've got a great family around me, and they're the people I listen to most. And the chairman said to me, go out and do what you do best, get your teams to play football. That's why he employed me. And I think today, the players have done that, and they've really passed the ball in a fantastic stadium, and I think in the end, we deserve the win.
Well, fantastic celebrations there. Mark Stimson talking earlier, and just wonderful for Gillingham. And as he says, it pays back that 7-0 fourfold, doesn't it, really? But the talking point is going to be that corner kick. You realise that, and that's going to be a talking point for our studio guests here. But let's go to Paul Stimson, who's the losing manager of Shrewsbury. Must be absolutely storming at this moment. But the man of the match is Simon King of Gillingham, and he's with Greg Whelan now.
Simeon, many congratulations. League One football next season, how does that sound?
It's the best feeling in the world. You know, we worked so hard all season, and just to get the reward at the end is just magnificent, magnificent.
It was a tough game for you personally. You had to wait for that moment, didn't you?
Yeah, I knew it would come. And luckily it came in the last minute, you know.
Not a bad place to score goal number 21 of the season, is it?
Oh, it's not bad at all. You hear that, it's just magnificent, absolutely magnificent.
Some of our special this day is Simon for Gillingham.
Unbelievable. Just listen to the fans. I can't even talk. My voice is gone. But credit to Jacko. He's done it all year. He scored some great goals for us. What a time to score. And but what a bat it was. Fair play to Shrewsbury. They gave everything. But we knew if we did our job at the back, and then we've got more than enough Billy up front to win us the game. And he shows he's done it again.
Look forward to next season. Charlton, Norwich, Leeds United, Southampton. Looking forward to that?
Oh, can't wait. Especially after last year, this point in relegation. What a way to bounce back, coming to Wembley and winning it here. Beautiful stadium and all the fans. What a day out for Gillingham. And all the players are absolutely buzzing now.
Congratulations on the day. You're also the Powerade Man of the Match. Simeon, do the honours for us, please. Well done, guys.
Well, relegated last season. The chairman, Paul Scally, and all the team back up again after one season, rebuilding with, by and large, non-league players. It's really paid off for Gillingham. As they go for their medals and receive the trophy, it'll be great scenes in the Medway Towns, I'm sure about that, and an amazing amount of support here for them. On average, gates of just over 5,000. Well, Peter Taylor, you know all about that, don't you, really? You know about Gillingham and the potential that there is there.
Yeah, I think you know, they bought the same amount last time we were here, and I think that you'd like the average gate to be more nearly like 10,000 when they play their league matches. But you know, they're going to enjoy their day, and I think over the 90 minutes they just about enjoyed it. I feel really sorry for Paul Stimson and Shrewsbury because it was a tough way to finish. But it's, you know, the Kent fans will go home, and the A2 and the M25 are going to be buzzing tonight, I should think.
Absolutely right. And Andy, overall, the right team?
Yeah, I think so. Certainly the first half they dominated. Having said that, there weren't many clear-cut chances in open play. It looked like the set pieces, and that's what it came down to in the end.
OK, let's go back to our commentators for the trophy lift, and Bill Leslie. Bill.
Thanks, George. Well, Mark Stimson among the party going up, and as we heard from him, it's a wonderful game sometimes for you. The lowest of the low, 12 months ago after relegation from League One, and the barrage of criticism that followed them down, and now of course the flip side, the joy of promotion for Gillingham Football Club, for Paul Scally, for Barry Fuller, who's had a real up and down season, of course health problems in the middle of it, but the last time 9 years ago that Gillingham were here, he was a fan. Now he's living the dream, leading them up the famous Wembley steps, and there is the trophy. The old cliche, isn't it, about how wonderful it is to win promotion this way. And it'll feel like the best way in the world for Gillingham. They did it after extra time. Looked like they would need extra time here to mirror that Wigan success 9 years ago. There can be only one today. And that one on the way to League One is Gillingham Football Club. The Garden of England is all rosy again. Young and old, Simon Royce, the 37-year-old, and all the young players building their way from non-league football, some from part-time football, up to League One, where they will play some big sides. What a team effort, though, Gary. First half, they absolutely dominated. Looked like it was going to get away from them. But in the end, can you begrudge them the victory? Harsh on the way it happened, but the overall result, you can't really argue with, can you?
Not at all. They were dominant in the first half. They approached the game magnificently. They moved the ball well. One and two touches. Shrewsbury just couldn't get out their own half. But give Paul Stimson all the credit second half. He changed it round and made things really difficult for Gillingham. And then you have to give them credit for responding to that. They're a bit bemused by, I think, the change, but they just came through it, and to get the goal as late as that, it was just unbelievable for them. I felt both the emotions, one of sitting on the pitch, distraught at losing in a Wembley final, and one being there. Brilliant feeling.
Well, all the squad rejoicing in this. Mark Stimson saying that his hardest decision of the day would be who to leave out of the match day 16. He was left on the bench here once as a player, but as a manager, FA Trophy success is one thing. Promotion, particularly coming on the heels of last season's relegation, is quite another. He said before this would be the biggest day of his football career. It'll now feel like it's the best day of his football career.
And it's the way they play. He's so positive in his approach with the way he sets up his teams. Three up front, pace up front, so solid at the back, well organised in midfield. He's got the balance perfectly right. And I was delighted to hear him after saying he hadn't got the characters last season. He's obviously discarded the ones he didn't think were right, and he's got this side buzzing.
Yeah, he's gone to non-league. The players he's known from his time there with Grays and Stevenage, brought them in, got some of those who perhaps might, he felt, have had their feet under the table, getting a little complacent. And young, hungry players have delivered the big prize here to start off this playoff weekend.
Yeah, I mean, it's pleasing on the eye the way they play. I just love to see teams move the ball quickly across midfield, play with verve and style. They were inventive from set pieces. It's just that Daniels kept them at bay, as he has done in the past against other teams. But what a feeling that is, walking down there with those medals around your neck.
It's a season that's lasted 51 weeks. He had them in for pre-season training on the 1st of June. 51 weeks later, they are promoted. A job very well done for Gillingham Football Club.
So Gillingham go up to League One, and what a League One it will be next season, including, of course, Andy Scott and Peter Taylor. And while we're celebrating with Gillingham, Shrewsbury will be thinking, was that a corner, won't they? They'll be absolutely gutted when they find out it wasn't a corner.
They will. It's, you know, sometimes these tyres are, you know, they can be changed with decisions like that. But you've still got to defend the corner, and they'll be really disappointed with the way they defend it. It looked like Moss was supposed to be marking Jackson and just got away from him. And you can't let a goal scorer like that have room in the box at any time of the game, let alone the last minute.
It was set up perhaps for Grant Holper in the end. Simeon Jackson in the air proved the difference.
Well, I think that's where it's a bit of a surprise, really. If you just send Jackson outpace somebody and score a goal, you're never surprised about that. But, you know, he's not the biggest, and to score the goal there, it's probably good movement, but very poor marking, you know, we think, from Shrewsbury. But I think one of the Shrewsbury defenders did question the decision straight away. So, unfortunately, it is a poor decision by the referee, and he should have been a goal kick.
Peter, since you got Gillingham up at Wembley in a playoff final, they've had some great days, and it's gone backwards since, hasn't it, really? Is this the start of something bigger and better for them?
Well, you hope so. I think Mark Stimson's done really well. It was a tough season for him last year, getting relegated in his first season there, and it was a brave appointment by Paul Scally, because at that time Mark hadn't been in the league. But everywhere he's been, he's had an organised team and a good football team, and Gray, Stevenage, they play, you know, good stuff, as they did today. I think Andy Hessenthaler done a brilliant job in the Championship for them, a long time, you know. People don't even think about that, but Andy done a terrific job there. And so you hope now, Gillingham, you know, potential of the area, it's got a great chance then of going up again.
We've seen teams doing very well from League Two to League One, haven't we, just last season alone, you know, with Peterborough and so on. Is it possible that Gillingham can go on from here again?
Well, I think it's going to be down to resources. You know, we've been talking about with the big sides that have come down from the Championship, and to, you know, to challenge those sort of sides is going to be a huge task for all of us coming up from League Two. From our point of view, consolidation and trying to find out what League One's about is the key next year. Whether Paul Scally gives Mark the funds to go and build, we don't know, but they'll enjoy the day. Worry about that tomorrow.
You're right, that's for next season. This is for now, and Gillingham are the League Two playoff winners. Tomorrow it's League One. Millwall against Scunthorpe, 1 o'clock, Sky Sports 1 and HD1. And then on Monday, Burnley against Sheffield United for the right to play in the Premier League. 2 o'clock, Sky Sports 1 and HD1. One big, very big talking point out of this game. We'll discuss it shortly with our guests. But it's Gillingham who take the trophy and promotion.
Heroes. They have made it to Rome. Manchester United.
There's a desire.
Barcelona.
There's a hunger.
They have conquered.
There's an ability beyond belief.
It's the biggest prize in club football.
Unbelievable!
A classic battle in glorious high definition.
Oh, devastating!
The final of the UEFA Champions League. Wednesday from 6, Sky Sports 1 and HD1.
number
118247. Mr. Director Rehab. Ah, isn't this nice? Just you and Carlton Palmer having a bet.
Shh.
You know that bet you lost on the game last night? Well, because the last goal was a header, Paddy Power refunded losing bets. Here you go. Put some Christy Berg on.
Before you bet, check out the money-back specials at paddypower.com.
Wow! It's cold! Stoke it up, lad! Hotter, Grummet! Oh. Huh? Paul? Excuse me, sons. new boiler, lad. That'll save us some pennies.
Empower Home Team only install energy-efficient boilers, which could save you up to £275 a year.
If you don't use your printer because the ink costs too much, then what's the point in having a printer? Switch to a Kodak all-in-one printer, and on average, you'll save £75 a year on ink. See how much you could save at printandprosper.com.
We need to send an expert.
A walking, talking, know-it-all.
Expert. A guru.
How about Wu?
Wu will do.
Where to?
First stop, Peru.
Then send Wu to Kathmandu.
What's next?
Timbuktu.
And area code 212.
So Timbuktu, Kathmandu, Peru, and 212?
All by 2:30.
Not a problem.
Need an expert? Push a button. That's the human network effect.
Phew.
Learn more at cisco.com/UK.
There are four islands nearby where the sun always shines, with spectacular beaches and a breathtaking natural landscape. Islands that have it all. These islands are my home. Come and enjoy them.
Paddy Power will refund losing bets on the Champions League final if there's a goal scored after 85 minutes during normal time.
Sky Bet. It matters more when there's money on it.
Gillingham win promotion at Wembley, beating Shrewsbury by a goal to nil. It was all Gillingham in the first half, but Shrewsbury did come back in the second half after being battered in the first 45 minutes. Shrewsbury could have won it. In the end, Gillingham took it. Controversial fashion, Barry Fuller is a Gillingham man through and through. He's with Greg Whelan.
Barry, congratulations. You had to be patient today, didn't you, Gillingham?
Yeah. Shrewsbury, you've got to give credit to them, they're a great side, they're big, strong, they're physical, they know, they play the game the right way, they matched us all the way, and obviously we just kept digging in. First half we had a few chances, second half to come out, to be fair, the first 25 minutes they were probably on top, they got the better of us. We dug in and the boy that scored the goal, Simeon Jackson, he's a goal scorer, he's done it all year, and he's the one that probably deserves the goal over the season, probably.
So, a great day for Gillingham Football Club. What does that mean to a Gillingham fan?
Yeah, I was a local lad to walk up downstairs and collect the trophy for your local team. What more does a boy want? It's every boy's dream. And to be back in League One, where we believe we should have been, to go to, like, there's some big clubs there now. It's like a mini championship. There's obviously massive clubs there. There's Leeds, Norwich, Southampton, Cholton. And obviously that's where we want to be. And we want to take that next step. We're a young squad. We're hungry. Everyone here there's hungry. There's, the average age is about 24. So everyone's hungry. You want to get onto that next level. You never know. Who knows what could happen next season? You never know.
Cast your mind back 3 or 4 months ago, you had quite serious illness yourself. Did you imagine then that your season could end quite like this?
No, nowhere near it. When I was in there, I thought my season was over. And the doctors and the medical staff at the club were brilliant. And they got me through it and got me back to match fit as quick as possible. So I'm thankful for them, otherwise I wouldn't be here today.
Barry, enjoy your celebrations. Well done today.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, chairman and manager, enjoy the moment. So does the goalkeeper of Gillingham, Simon Royce.
Simon, 37 years of age, you get to play at Wembley at last and you're a winner. How does that feel?
It's fantastic. You've only got to look around you at these people here. This is what it's all about, you know. It took me 18 years to get here. Nice bit of silverware to go with it. lads have been fantastic all season. Simeon's popped up with a goal in the 90th minute, and how bad's that? A lot were made of the 7-0 earlier on in the season, but it's a one-off game, cup final, and just thankfully we came out on top.
But referring to the 7-0, did you owe Shrewsbury today a little?
I think it gave it a little bit of an extra edge, especially for me personally, the heaviest defeat I've suffered in 18 years. So I had the bit between my teeth, and so did the lads. But we ground out a result. I thought first half their goalkeeper made two fantastic saves. He's got a bright future in the game. But we're just going to enjoy our day, and it's for all these people here.
You had to wait for it. You had to grind it out, as you rightly say. Did you always believe?
Yeah, we did. Like I said, we were good first half. Shrewsbury are obviously going to have their little bit of play in the second half. They're a strong side. Don't take nothing away from them. And I think they'll get automatic promotion next year if they can keep the squad together. But we did believe. We have dug in. We're a fit side. And I think that showed at the end.
And until Simeon Jackson put that one in right at the end, as goalkeeper at the other end, did you think penalties might be looming?
I did, to be honest. I didn't fancy extra time. The lads looked like they were starting to tire a little bit. But like I said, 90th minute, what a good time to score.
Enjoy your day, Simon.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Yeah, Gillingham have done it. Let's see how. And we're sitting as far away as you can from the goal scored. I think we all said corner. It wasn't a corner. It was a goal kick at the same time. So why wasn't that seen closer in?
You don't know. Peter mentioned it straight away. He said, goal kick. Don't know whether the referee can't see it. The linesman's on this side. It's clear it comes off of his knee, diverts that way. And straight away you can see a Shrewsbury player's appealing for it. But, Mosses has switched off. I don't know whether it's playing on his mind that he thinks that it was a goal kick. He's just left Jackson there. The lad on the post should be on the post and could hit it away. He comes off the post. It's a comedy of errors, really, but it's not very funny for Shrewsbury, and they've lost the game because of it.
It really is a bad goal. I think Ashton there should head that away with ease, And
you see, as managers, you're seeing it from that point of view, aren't you? Forget the corner, all you defenders, forget the corner.
Yeah.
Just defend it.
For me, Ashton on the far post should move. The minute the goalkeeper moves, you don't have to stay on that post all the time. And to me, he could be a little bit closer to the ball. Okay, I think he hasn't headed it because I think he thinks he's going to head the post or whatever. But to me, that should have been cleared. So unfortunately for Paul, he'll be looking at that and he'll be very, very frustrated.
If we talk about Paul Simpson, who was given a decent budget at the start of the season, wasn't he, to work with in League Two, certainly at League Two level.
Well, I think what he found was that he brought a lot of players in, some of them on big money, and it didn't quite gel as quickly as he wanted. Lots been made of their away record throughout the season was awful. Home record was fantastic, and they picked up towards the end of the season, but it was a little bit too little too late. And they did much better second half. They were awful first half, and Paul had been really disappointed with that, but had been delighted with the way they started the second half. And to be honest, Simon Rice made a fantastic save from Ben Davis early in the second half that kept it at 0-0. But then Gillingham just imposed himself a little bit, and I think they deserve to go through.
In fact, these two teams were the bookies' favourites at the start of the season, weren't they, to go up automatically?
Yeah, I think again, you look at Grant Holt, you really fancy any team that have a striker that's probably going to get you 20-odd goals are always going to be up there. And so I think everybody fancied Shrewsbury. We were the same. We got belted 7-0 in a Johnson Paint Trophy game, so I understand a little bit how Gillingham are feeling. I think I'm very pleased for Gillingham. I think in the end, they were the form team in the end. Andy's done superb at Brentford, of course, but a few of us had a wobble. We all had a bit of a wobble, but I thought Gillingham were getting stronger and stronger, so that's why they're here, and fair play to them.
Another Southern team?
Yep, it's another part to the Southern League of League
Chairman
One.
Chairman are delighted. The hotels are not very pleased. We're not going up north very much.
The travel.
We're just hoping they bring some of that 38,000 to our place.
that's for sure. OK, we'll talk with the manager of Shrewsbury, Paul Simpson, after the break. What a day for him. What a season, if you like. But certainly, he's just come short on the final day of his season. Shrewsbury go out